All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back once again. It is Tuesday, the Hot Tag Podcast with yours truly, Shaheen, and my co-host, the main man.
The Vox Man. What is going on, Shaheen? How are you, my friend?
I am doing great, man. I can't complain. We've had a pretty decent week for wrestling. I mean, honestly, a pretty good month, actually.
You know, 2015 could actually turn out to be a pretty interesting year for wrestling. I mean, we got a lot of shows getting TV. We got some new promotions coming out. I don't know, man. Could be interesting. Could be non-WWE interesting, which is even better.
Awesome. That's what we're looking forward to. Not to be WWE bashers. You know, I don't want to be, because the product is good. Of course, you know, I enjoy it. But to be honest, I mean, last night's Raw, which we're going to get into in detail, but for the most part, the only enjoyable part was Wyatt against Ambrose. And, you know, to be honest, we've seen that match several times. So it's, I don't know, man. It's hard to find interest in the WWE right now, to say the least.
It was hard to find something good to say about that show last night, too. So
last couple of weeks, not just last night. I mean,
well, I thought last night might have been one of the, I mean, for their first show of the new year, I think it should have been, you know, just a little better than what it was. God damn, that was shit.
Yeah, it was pretty fucking bad. But I'm going to be a man of my word and actually go back on my word, because I was making fun of Jeff Jarrett for saying that there's a wrestling boom coming. And in all honesty, we might be seeing a wrestling boom. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't mean that there is, you know, 11 million people watching, you know, Raw again or wrestling in general, but you can't deny the fact that there's about 5 or 6 different promotions that are picking up. You know, we're getting a couple different promotions that we can actually watch their shows now. You know, it's not just indies. So, you know, it's not Pro Wrestling Guerrilla where you have to go and buy the DVDs just to keep up with it. You can actually watch these shows. Now, I'm going to go ahead and say this. Lucha Underground, I can actually watch it now, so I can judge it with a better perspective because I can actually see the fucking show. Mm-hmm. So I'm really enjoying that, so that's one. We had Global Force Wrestling presenting New Japan Wrestling, which we're going to get into.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but New Japan, they have a show that's starting, right?
Yes. So, on Axis, I don't know what that channel is, where to get it, but yes, Axis.
Yeah, it used to be HDNet. So if you get HDNet, if you're more familiar with that, it's the same channel.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I don't know if I get it or not, but yeah. So New Japan,
I might.
Lucha Underground.
Yep.
According to Jeff Jarrett, I guess he is actually going to have a roster, and he's going to have a TV deal in 2015. And, you know, we can say what we want about Jarrett, but of course, you know, judging off him selling 8x10s before he has a roster, I mean, it's comical, but we're going to give him a chance. At least I'm going to give him a chance. I think it actually might be good, because I think he has a good wrestling mind, and he actually adapts to the times. You know, he's not like Vince McMahon. So it might be good. So there we got three. We got Global Force, we got New Japan, we got Lucha Underground, we got Ring of Honor that you can watch, right? We got NXT, which is phenomenal. We got the WWE, we got TNA with like 1,000 shows, right? And now, how many different promotions is that? That's like 7 or 8 right there.
That's
at least 6. And now we have Pro Wrestling Syndicate. Good promotion out of the Northeast. They actually have a lot of big names coming in, so it's not like a normal indie where you're just going to see some random guy just out of high school in fucking, you know, in swimming trunks, running ropes and shit. You're not going to see that. It's going to be good stuff. So I highly recommend anybody that may have the channel. I'm not sure. I probably should have researched it so I can give you guys more information about what channel it's going to be on. But you can check it out on their Facebook. Go check it out, Pro Wrestling Syndicate. You can check it out on their YouTube, Pro Wrestling Syndicate. So, Jeff Jarrett, you may be right. There is a wrestling boom. If you know, if he's talking about wrestling promotions, you know, basically starting up again, and it's almost like it's territories again, isn't it? It's similar.
It's getting there, man. People are just trying to start and take some of the heat and get some stuff going, and I'm loving it, man. But there is one thing I did want to mention before we get going. TNA. Last week we were wondering if it was on Wednesdays or Fridays.
Right.
Both of us were technically correct. This week it is on tomorrow night. They're going to be live tomorrow night. Starting after this week, it will be on Fridays.
I thought I said that, didn't I?
No, it's Wednesday nights. You had said it was on Friday nights, and I think we just kind of said, oh, we'll check. So either way, it's tomorrow. Tomorrow is a TNA marathon of best of all day on Destination America. So if you've got nothing to do, watch TNA all day and all night.
Now, you know what it is, what is annoying about TNA being on Destination America?
What?
I tried to set up my DVR so, you know, obviously it can record TNA because I'm not watching it live, of course.
Okay. And,
I'm getting some background sound. I can hear myself. Are you playing me out loud in the back or no?
No, I can't hear it. I got nothing. Hold on. This happened the other day and it went away after a minute or two.
Yeah, fuck it. Anyway, TNA. The way that they have their show set up, it really confuses my DVR because... you know, their best of shows, technically the title is different every show, so my DVR apparently isn't smart enough to figure that out. So it just thinks it's a one-time special. So I have to record it every week, and I have to remember to actually set the recording. That's pretty annoying.
Yeah, that should change after a week.
I don't know, man. I skipped a couple weeks ahead and looked at the schedule, and once I set the thing on record for that show, it wasn't recording the following week, so I had to set
the record by the name of the show. Oh, I got you. That sucks.
Yeah, it's pretty annoying. So, TNA, fix that, man. That's really just amateur stuff right there.
I actually don't think that's TNA's fault. I think that would be your cable company's fault. Oh. Who do you...
Verizon Fios.
Oh, see, I got Fios, and I just hit record series. Boom.
Yeah, that's what I do. That's what I do. And it's going to record TNA Impact every week. But the best of show, since the title is different every week, one week is best of Bully Ray, one week is best of, I don't know, whoever, Magnus, I guess it confuses a DVR, so it only thinks it's just that one time.
Yeah, I got it.
The TNA Impact, it does record that every week. But, these other shows, I mean, I don't really care. I don't think I need three, different episodes of a TNA show a week.
No, but I did notice on Destination America, it is also playing directly, there's TNA, something in the middle, and then TNA replays.
That's because they don't have too many shows, man. They have,
Good for TNA, man. They can take over that channel, maybe. I mean, it can't hurt them, what they're doing now. Well, it can hurt them, let me rephrase that. I don't know. This may be a big thing for me. A lot of people said they should get off a Spike and get on a better channel, but, maybe a smaller channel is better for them. We'll see, I guess.
Well, let's give Spike some credit. They did, they helped them out with bills. They gave them a decent amount of advertising and promotion. I mean, can't really just say it wasn't them, It's not really their fault.
Maybe promotion... I don't know. And I think they were forcing some of those Bellator guys on them and to do this and do that, which a lot of times made their show seem silly. So, I don't know, man. Maybe it's just me. But, I don't know. You on mute?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I forgot I put myself on mute for a second. I was talking, and I'm like, why the fuck isn't he answering? Anyway.
Because I can hear you.
Right. But TNA, yeah, a couple new shows apparently, a new logo, a new channel. Hopefully it's a new startup.
Well, if you saw the thing I put on Facebook today, they are looking to do a kind of reality TV type wrestling show. So let's just see how it works out. I'm really just going to give it a chance. I'm not going to give it just 1 week. I'm going to give it like a month before I tear into it.
Well, that's kind of stealing the whole Global Force thing, isn't it? That was Jarrett's idea.
Well, TNA's always been a little more reality-based with the, you know, I mean, they got the documentary cam doing the backstage stuff, and they've always been a little more reality TV style shooting, if you've noticed, you know, so.
Yeah, they pretend like the camera's not there and it's hiding in the back and.
Yeah, you know.
It's kind of creepy, isn't it?
Mm.
Just like a random camera guy just sneaking up on everybody.
I don't know. I've always just thought, well, why don't you fucking people just sit there and go, well, there's probably going to be a camera. Why shouldn't I go outside to talk about this?
Oh, if you want to bring logic into wrestling, I'll definitely take all the enjoyment out of it.
I just said I think it. I don't want to bring it in.
Yeah, yeah.
I think they need to do more Jeff Hardy inner monologue segments. I swear I loved those.
I didn't see them, so I can't comment, but sounds interesting.
All right, that's fine. So
that's fine. But, yeah, so anyway, before we get onto it, check out Pro Wrestling Syndicate. You can see John Morrison. What's his name in Lucha Underground? Johnny Mundo. So you can check out Johnny Mundo against Jushin Thunder Liger. I was there for that match. Awesome match. They have a bunch of different stuff, man. Great Muda was up there. Rob Van Dam against AJ Styles. Freaking Young Bucks, Briscoes, Rock and Roll Express, you name it, they were there. So, check it out.
Hell yeah. You say Rock and Roll Express, I'm down.
Yeah, I actually, Rock and Roll Express against the Briscoes. I was there for that.
Wow.
Odd matchup, isn't it? The Briscoe brothers, like the new Briscoes?
I got you, with an E.
Right. Yeah, well, I just want to, you know, in case anybody's confused. Yeah, they didn't put 80-year-old men in the ring with each other.
No. You know, speaking of, Sam Roberts had a good interview with Jay Briscoe.
I did listen to that. Very enjoyable.
Yeah, that was a damn good interview. I was a little taken back by it. I thought it was just going to be like a Jamie Dundee, you know, interview or something, you know, all over the place. But pretty damn good interview. I liked it. Sam does a good job if you can kind of just block out his voice.
I enjoy Sam. I like him. And, you know, check out, I keep saying his name, man. I keep forgetting his name, man. Peter Rosenberg, that's his name. Peter Rosenberg, Hot 97. He has a wrestling podcast, and he brings on a lot of people, so check him out, man. Cheap Heat, that's a good podcast. Sam Roberts goes on a show a lot. They recently had Mike Tyson just randomly call in. They had Bray Wyatt randomly call in. They have a bunch of different people, so check that out, man. It's good stuff.
I know Cheap Heat is an ESPN show.
Well, yeah, it's actually it's under the ESPN catalog for podcasts. So it's an ESPN, you know, podcast.
Yeah, I've tried to listen to it. I'm whatever.
Oh, I don't know. Some people might enjoy it. I enjoy it. I don't know.
Yeah, you know. Hey, the guy that keeps telling me about it at work loves it. So. I don't know, man. I can barely listen to all the podcasts I've got on my phone right now.
I can barely keep up with wrestling, dude. We get so much fucking wrestling now. And we're getting more in 2015. So, God, man, we're going to have like 8-hour marathons of hot tech podcasts.
Oh. Well, we'll just do more shows if that happens.
We should just get like a Red Bull to sponsor us. So we just get free Red Bulls all the time and we can do like 9-hour podcasts.
We're sponsored by Red Bull and Meth. Yeah, Red Bull and crystal meth. This is how you keep awake all day.
And cocaine.
Shit.
Is that why you got the sniffles in the background, man?
Yeah, except for the head cold I've got because this goddamn state is warm 1 week, freezing the next, raining the next, freezing the next, warm again.
It's funny you say that, man. Right now in Philadelphia, it's kind of been the same this year. Usually it's always just cold, but this year, one day it's hot, one day it's snowing. Perfect example today. We're getting our first snow, so.
Yeah.
Snowed in.
Yeah, they're saying we could have some snow. We actually had an earthquake today. I was at my office and my feet started shaking.
Man, that would scare the shit out of me.
Well, I started asking around and like two people didn't feel it, and I'm sitting there going, oh, fuck, how fucking high am I? You know, but then finally someone said, hey, we just had an earthquake. Did anyone feel it? I'm like, oh, fuck, thank God someone else felt it.
Well, he was probably high, too.
No, he doesn't smoke.
But you know what they say, that weed gives you the spidey senses.
Man, I felt that. I really, but and then I looked on the news, and I actually saw articles about it from like 7 minutes ago, which is, you know, which was when I felt it. So I felt a little better. I mean, I knew I was still high, but at least I wasn't too high, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying. You know, you felt it because you were high, and your you know, sensitivity or senses or whatever you want to say may have been.
My fucking desk shook, but anyway.
Yeah. So, well, shit, it was an earthquake.
Yeah, yeah, that was the first one I've ever been through, seen, heard, felt, whatever.
John Tenta.
That was it. First one I've ever been through, so.
But before we get into Raw, which I'm not really excited about, let's talk about Vinnie McMahon. Yeah!
What you got to say about me, pal?
Yeah. Vince McMahon, apparently, I mean, these are my words, so quote me, but from what I read, and I'm just paraphrasing, he's pretty much jealous of the NXT products, which is fucking weird to me. I don't get it. It's your product, ultimately. So what? It's run by Triple H, man. Who gives a shit? I mean, I don't know. I guess it is hurting his ego because, you know, like the minor leagues, although it's his minor league, is defeating the big leagues, and, you know, I guess it's killing his soul. But I just find it very weird. It seems like he's going to hold a grudge against them. This is what the dirt sheets say. So, you know, don't believe the dirt sheets all the time. So for all I know, it could be complete bullshit. But I'm just taking it as fact, and I'm spitting facts at you guys. Once the dirt sheet news goes to the Hot Tag Podcast, it pretty much becomes just facts, whether it's true or not. It becomes facts to us. So. It is spitting facts. What was that? Froze up on me for a second. What was that?
I said, we got microphones. It's true.
It's true.
It's damn true.
Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle style.
I didn't get copyrighted for that. Damn.
It's true. It's true. But, yeah, what do you think about this, man? Vince McMahon looking down on the NXT product because people are chanting NXT when Big Show comes out, when John Cena comes out. What can you fucking blame him? It's entertaining, and your product is not, sir.
Yeah, I read that article. I think I posted it. So, yeah, it doesn't make much sense, but it's kind of with the way you can see from people have described Mr. Vince McMahon. That's about how I expect something to go in his mind, that, oh, they're cheering for those rookies. Oh, no, that's not what they're supposed to be doing. They're supposed to be cheering for my guys and, you know.
Supposed to be cheering for John Cena.
Yeah, forget the fact everybody for the past, I mean, they're showing those videos of John Cena last night. They're like 2002 and Cena had the same song, and I'm like, oh, or 2005, and I'm like, oh, my God, 10 years of this fucking music.
Yeah. I mean, 10 years of this fucking guy. Forget the music of this guy.
But, I mean, he hasn't even changed his music in 10 years.
Yeah. Rubble!
Oh, jeez.
I hate that sound, by the way. What is that? What is that shit?
I don't know, man.
Who thought that was cute to put that in the beginning of the song? What is that shit?
Shaheen, you're being asked to go in the chat room. They have Astat picks and Cena picks.
All right. I have to.
I'm not sure if you want the Astats or the Cena picks most, but
I definitely don't want the Cena picks because that'll probably go right in the garbage. But let's check out the Astats. These are going to be
probably Astats. They're probably here. So. There you go. If you need the link to the chat room, it's on the Facebook page for anyone out there who gives a shit.
And the Facebook page is facebook.com/groups/THT podcast. God damn it.
Exactly.
And don't put the goddamn it in there. It's not in there.
No, please don't put the goddamn it in there. Well, go ahead. Who cares?
Well, yeah, go ahead. Who cares? What do you know? Won't be able to get in.
Do what you want, people. That's what we're all about here. Do what the fuck you want to do. There you are. Shaheen has joined the chat. There you go. Come on in with us, people. Listen live. Chat with me and Shaheen and the other cast of insane characters posting ass tattoo pics.
Did you say Gucci?
No, I don't think so.
All right.
Did I?
I thought you were asking for Gucci, man, and I was saying.
No. Oh, dude, there was, requests for it the other night.
Yeah, Gucci Man died last week. By the way, speaking of Gucci Man, apparently he got raped in jail recently. So what the fuck is that?
Damn.
Yeah, three times. Three times at that. So.
Tell us how that felt, Gucci.
All right, man, I can't talk about it, man. You know how it go, Playa, man. Can't talk about that shit, man. I guess they just thought I was sweet because I had the ice cream cone and shit on my cheek. But, you know, they try to go for my cheeks because I got ice cream on my cheek. But, hey, it is what it is, man. Gucci, man, I'm back out. I'm out here and shit, man. Still got the motherfucker pissed on my lap while I'm doing the goddamn hot dad podcast and shit, man. But I'm going to give it back to Shane over here, man, because I'm going to get locked up again, go back to jail and shit, get some more tattoos.
All right. Appreciate that, Gucci man.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Be careful out there, man.
All right, Gucci, you can please leave. Thank you.
Mama said lock your ass.
Please.
Lock it. Lock that shit.
Duct tape it. Just be careful with the sack, you know. You want to peel that off. It's probably going to kill you.
Oh, God. What was that Martin Lawrence thing where he did that? Mama said lock your ass.
You know, I was never a big fan of Martin Lawrence.
He's
really overrated, dude. He's not funny.
He does some funny stuff. I mean, I'm not like, oh my God, Martin Lawrence is great, but he's got some funny stuff. I don't hate him. I'm not like I said, I ain't crazy about him, but I don't hate him. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
As far as like black comedians, I like Dave Chappelle a lot. I think he's like one of the best ones out there ever.
No, Chris Rock.
Oh, dude, Chris Rock sucks, man. Are you serious?
Chris Rock is great. Eddie Griffin, there's that. That's one of the best right there.
Dude, I saw Eddie Griffin live, and it was the most fucking awkward thing ever.
Well, he talks a lot about his life and his family.
No, it was just awkward because I was the only non-black person in the whole place.
Oh. But
literally. I mean that literally.
But I still bet I'm sure it was still funny.
I mean, he used to be funny. Honestly, recently he kind of fell off. When I went there, I regretted going 5 minutes within the show because, I don't know, man, the jokes just weren't landing like it used to, and it just seems like he just curses too much. That's coming from me, so, I mean, damn. Just imagine. Yeah, honestly, it was just him just saying fuck the whole time. I didn't hear anything else.
Damn, you would have hated to go to a Richard Pryor show back in the day, or Eddie Murphy.
It was worse than that.
Damn, Eddie Murphy's awesome too. I love those old
Delirious. Raw and Delirious are awesome. And yeah, Richard Pryor, I've seen a lot of his stand-ups. I mean, it wasn't from my era, but I've seen his stand-ups. But hey, man, Eddie Griffin, yeesh, a little too much for me, man.
I don't know, man. I watched his what was it, Dysfunctional Family, and that was funny as hell.
Well, if you found that funny, it was very similar to that.
Yeah, I guess I like when people just go like John Leguizamo goes up, talks about his life, talks about his family, and makes it funny. I like that stuff. Like if you've never seen that Mike Tyson one man show, you should watch that, dude. That's badass.
Mike Tyson one man show?
Mike Tyson does a show called, oh my God, let me get it because I don't want to mess it up. I think it's Mike Tyson Undisputed, if I'm not mistaken. I just want to make sure. But he literally it was on HBO for a while.
What exactly is it? Is it a stand-up?
It's literally a one-man show. Here it is, a one-man show where he goes up there and just talks about from when he was a kid. Okay, it's called Mike Tyson, The Undisputed Truth, and it is from HBO Films. I'm 90% sure you can probably go on your on-demand and get this. This is something you need to watch, dude. It is great. He sits there and he talks about his life. He's open, honest. It's funny. It's Mike Tyson talking about it, so it's even better. But, I mean, he's dead. dead honest about a lot of stuff, man. Even that rape, he goes, he talks openly about that rape charge he got and says, I did not do it. I've done a lot of shitty things in my life, but I did not do that. So,
now speaking of Mike Tyson and the rape case, did you catch the clip of him on a news show? And I guess one of the newscast guys, he asked him, he didn't really ask him, he kind of brought it up, like, subliminally, and he, Mike Tyson lost his shit. He really just got pissed off.
Yeah, I did. And he had also said that it was kind of like the punk thing. He said, he basically said, off the air, you're all nice to me, and then you get me on here, motherfucker, and then I choke you the fuck out.
You just said he was a piece of shit. He's like, no, fuck that, you're a piece of shit. Fuck I you. Like that, though.
And then the guy has, nice having you on here, Mike. Oh, fuck you.
Nah, you're a piece of shit. That's, I don't like that, though. Anything the guy just said, he said, nah, fuck that, you're a piece of shit.
Now I want to pull that up and play it, because that was fucking awesome.
Nah, fuck that, you're a piece of shit. I can't do the Mike voice, but, you know, I love that. That was hilarious, man.
That was awesome.
You see the clip of him talking about he's gonna put somebody's, like, baby in a microwave and fucking microwave it and eat it and all this crazy shit?
He's got some crazy stuff like that. When that reporter was talking to him and said, this person said this about you and said that you would want a rape, he goes, well, now I want a waper.
Yeah, he's wild, man. He's a wild dude.
Well, he talks about how a lot of that time he was very coked up.
Yeah, I bet.
I'll pretty much guarantee that's where a lot of those tirades came from. So, speaking of coke, John Jones tested positive for cocaine. You believe that shit? Do you know anything about that?
Absolutely not.
You know who John Jones, right?
Absolutely not.
You don't know the okay, John Jones, Daniel Cormier just had a fight over on Saturday.
Oh, this guy? I've seen him. Oh, guy with the beard. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, yeah. We don't do much MMA talk on here, but I did want to see that fight because of all the hype that was on it, and man, he ran the fuck over Cormier. But I don't know. It was a weird fight.
This guy, I don't know.
Guy's got a 12. I mean, I don't know how it can't be a weird fight when a guy's got a 12-inch reach on you. So.
Yeah, I caught the preview or commercial or whatever you want to call.
Yeah, it had a lot of hype. I mean, these guys were pushing each other around at weigh-ins and press conferences. So.
How much of that do you believe? Do you think a lot of that is staged just to gain more buy rates and all that stuff?
I think some of it might be. I think some of it might not be. I mean, you guys, I guess, really hate each other. But, again, it's on television. I have a hard time taking anything on television and taking it for reality. So,
nah.
Oh, man. I don't know. It'd be a good question to have answered one day. But I think it'll take a long time to do that.
I mean, we can pretty much go ahead and say I'm sure a lot of it is staged, man. I don't really need that question answered.
I'm sure a lot of it is, but I'd like to think for as much that's staged, there's just as much that's not.
It may be, but I'm sure they stage a lot of it just for money. I mean, it makes sense, you know. You hype up the match, you make it personal. It's you know, it's something out of the box, and you gain buy rates, and that equals money.
It's called promoting. I mean,
exactly.
At the end of Rocky, you know, at the end of Rocky One, they weren't going to fight again. And then right when they get to the hospital in front of the TVs, he's talking trash again. Apollo, talking shit.
Talking that shit. But he was crying like a pussy.
You was crying like a pussy.
Yeah. Crying like a pussy.
I got us a new main event sound, too.
Nice.
Yeah, we'll play that later.
There you go, folks. You have to listen for another 2 hours just to hear the main event sound.
All right, I'll play it. I got Bruce Buffer.
No, you have to make him wait.
Oh, that one doesn't sound like it did the other day.
Fuck that.
Yeah, that one didn't sound good. It sounded better the other day.
Fuck that, bruh.
So I did not get a new main event one.
Oh man, this guy. What was his name again? The Ultimate Fighter. I saw a picture of his toe, man. His toe got fucking like cut in half or something. Man, have you seen this?
Which one?
The guy's bone is hanging out of his toe.
Whose?
The black dude doing coke.
John Jones?
I guess, yeah. John Jones, Indiana Jones, whatever fuck. His toe's cut in half, bro. Go check it out. It's disgusting.
I wonder how that happened.
Probably fighting.
Couldn't have been that fight. Now, John Jones.
No, it's not from that fight, but it's.
Oh, yeah. Then, I've seen it. I thought it was from that fight. I'm like, damn, there's no way Cormier got in that close on the motherfucker. But
No. I don't know what fight it's from. And why the fuck? I'm not a fan of this guy. I can tell you that already.
I don't know, man. He's big. He's got long legs, long arms. John Jones, he's just like, I don't know if you remember the old fighter, Chemo. He was just like that, man. Long arms, long legs. Ken Shamrock actually beat the shit out of that dude, but don't worry about that.
Ken Shamrock lost to that Japanese dude that was on the New Japan.
Sakuraba.
Yeah, Sakuraba, yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of New Japan, since you got to go soon, we probably should get into it, shouldn't we?
Well, I'm going to wait on this phone call because I have to go and pick somebody up. But I haven't got a call any time, so I still have time. But
so we'll just we'll go until we got to go. Then that's fine. So yeah,
we should be fine, man. But well,
keep talking about whatever the bullshit we're talking about. But the chat room's even saying Dana White, president of UFC, is a big Vince McMahon guy. I know they've had meetings, so anything staged wouldn't surprise me one bit.
Yeah, I mean, it makes money. It's not even about being a fan of Vince McMahon. It makes fucking money.
Huh?
I said you tuned out. I couldn't hear you.
No, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just saying it's not even about being a fan of the WWE or Vince McMahon. It makes money. The guy likes money. He's a fan of money.
It does, and I guarantee this pay-per-view did some good buy rates for them. So we'll see. But just like Weeble just said, Dana knew he lost a lot of money when Brock left, and he did. He did. He lost a lot. He lost a lot of buy rates when Brock left that company, but. I don't know, man. I don't think he's done a huge business for WWE, so I don't know, man. I'm still not sure if we're going to see him after Mania.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you. Since you brought up Brock Lesnar, do you think he's going to stick around? Because I sure as hell don't. It doesn't really seem like he's sticking around. Just a gut feeling.
No. Yeah, exactly. Gut feeling. He could probably go for, let's see, if he had a 50. All right, okay, let's go 25 dates on his contract for WWE. He could probably get the same contract, fight 2 to 3 fights for, like, Bellator, and barely work.
Yeah, but he has to train, though.
I think training to him is just part of life. I think that's probably what drives him anyway. So I don't think training to him is training. I think training is just a daily routine for him anyway, so who knows, but
yeah.
I don't see him coming back to wrestling. I mean, why? I don't know. I don't see it, and I think he's a very lucky guy to where in the next month or two, he's going to have three companies really, you know, pushing and pulling for him, so yeah. I don't mean pushing and pulling in that bad way, by the way.
I know what you mean, man.
Yeah, I didn't mean like in a Kamala way or nothing. You know.
Pushing and pulling.
Yeah, I didn't mean it that
way. God damn it, man. If YouTube is making me fucking, hold on. I may have to upgrade again this fucking thing.
Oh, dude, I don't hear it.
You don't hear it?
No, I don't hear the dinging.
Okay, I'm just going to hear the dinging. Hold on, give me 1 second. Please just take over a minute or two. Let me try to figure this out. YouTube, you're a bastard.
Sure, I don't know. Let's see. Chat room, what do you guys think about Brock? Brock probably leaves for a couple years. I don't know. I just don't see him staying. I don't know why he would. He's going to have Bellator probably throwing money at him. And they've got, you know, Viacom behind him. He's going to have UFC throwing money at him again, and that's UFC money. I don't even have to explain that one. Then, then he's going to have WWE, which, whether they throw money at him or not, I don't know. I'm not sure if they will. They may just, I don't know. I really don't, but.
I don't think they will, man. I don't think. In their eyes, he's a good investment anymore.
Well, I would say if he did come back, you would have to have him work more dates, which is probably not something he wants to do.
I mean, especially with the network, because, you know, it's I don't think he's made a big change in the buy rates or the subscription rate.
I don't think so. I mean, really, again, we can't tell because of the network, but I don't think he's jumped the needle much. I don't know. Maybe he'll go to TNA.
I mean, clearly he hasn't, because when they first debuted the network, they had about, what, 600,000 subscribers? Something like that?
Yeah.
They're pretty much at the same place now. So, you know, making Brock the champion clearly didn't move the needle, as they like to refer to it as.
Yeah, and I don't think that's on Brock at all. I mean, let's face it, his first match back, they bring him in against Cena, and what happens? Cena lays him out. 1, 2, 3. Brock's looking at the lights. Why would you bring this monster in and immediately have him lose to Cena? It just doesn't make sense to me, but I think we've been down this road before. We probably shouldn't go back down it again.
That is true. So you can't hear this sound.
No, I do not hear anyone pounding on a railroad like it used to be. It sounded like they were nailing in a railroad tie.
Yeah. That's what it's almost like a Chinese torture method.
Yeah, I don't hear it, but if it's bothering you that much, we can do what we got to do. But I do not hear it.
Here, well, I'll tell you what. Let's do Raw, because this thing's gonna drive me absolutely nuts. I already know, especially with the headphones. I'm gonna end up breaking this computer screen.
But that's why I can't hear it, because you got the headphones on.
Right. But let's go over Raw, and then we'll do a new video just doing Global Force, New Japan, whatever you want to call it. And then we'll do that separate video.
Yeah, we can do that. We'll take a quick break. I'll probably have to pee because I'm on my second Heineken already.
Cool. Well, we're talking about Brock Lesnar, so let's just go ahead and segue into Raw.
Let's just go ahead and get into WWE Raw.
Raw is not war.
No. Raw last night.
Pussy fest.
Well, more like a sausage fest. I'll say this. A lot of people really, by the Facebook reaction, or should I say by the IWC reaction,
Goddamn
the IWC hated Raw last night. I didn't think it was horrible. I will say I did have some things to, I was, my laptop took a dump when I got home yesterday. My 2-year-old dropped it.
Whoa.
And my hard drive wouldn't read, and Windows got kicked out. I had some work to do on my laptop last night. So I was in the middle of doing some stuff, so maybe that's why it went a little quick and I didn't mind it so bad. I wasn't paying attention like I should have or like I usually do.
Dude, I was on my phone like probably at least half the time.
I did find myself on my phone playing Trials Frontier and Angry Birds.
There you go.
Yeah, Angry Birds Friends, of course. I don't know. It was an interesting Raw, to say the least. To me, it looked very WCW 2000 thrown together last minute, and from what I read, it was rewritten at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
And why did they do that? I mean, I can understand why they did it when CM Punk left, but I don't know, man. Was it really necessary? Was Raw really an improvement from what it was originally? I mean, we don't know what the original plan was, but I'm sure it probably wouldn't have been much different than
Well, if this was the rewritten script, the other one must have been really, really bad.
It was actually probably really good.
It probably was, and they're like, this is too good. They liked NXT, pal.
Yeah.
Do you get it? Punish them.
Punish these bastards.
Punish these motherfuckers.
You know what we should do?
What should we do?
We should do a new podcast and call it Fuck the IWC. And we should pretty much just troll everyone and just talk about and just really be positive and just love everything that WWE does and be completely serious about it, you know? I think that would be gold.
That's Sam Roberts' podcast.
No, not really. I mean, he puts them down at times.
But he kisses them.
Yeah, but he does because he wants to work for them, man. He's playing. Oh,
I know. And he, like I said, he's done some network stuff, so technically he's got the foot in the door, if you will.
Yeah.
But I don't know. That technically would make us the IWC since we would put our show on the internet for people to listen to.
It doesn't matter, man. We're fucking around anyway. But I bet you, man, that thing would blow up.
Probably.
You would get death mail and death wishes and fucking all kinds of crazy shit.
We could do it as different characters. I ain't doing it as myself. I mean,
you are Box, man. You can just put an avatar as a fucking Box with eyes.
Oh, no. I'd have to be like fucking Rick Diesel or something from...
Rick Diesel.
Rick Diesel from Eddie and the Cruisers 2.
I'll just be Gucci Mane.
There you go. I'll just make myself...
That would be hard. Do like an hour of Gucci Mane a week.
I'll just do the morning DJ guy.
Morning DJ guy. There you go, man. Nobody would be able to tell.
Yeah. Hey, we're going out here. We're going to talk to the IWC. You know those guys are great, aren't they? Anyway, we're going to...
We should do it, man. There you go. Just started it off right.
Who knows? Anyway.
Cult of Kayfabe would probably, you know, want to kill us.
Oh, dude.
What? They like Cena? Fuck dude, those bastards. Fuck those bastards.
Some of the people on that group are really dense.
Yeah. Oh, dude, they take it serious.
They take it too serious.
They're still like, real to me, damn it.
That's exactly who they remind me of. I mean, they take it like, I mean, and they've got rules and shit.
Oh, shit, yeah, hell yeah, dude. I try to, like, post up one of our things, and somebody, like, sent me, like, a fucking, like, 6 paragraphs. I'm like, dude, it's the fucking internet. Like, you don't have clout. This isn't, like,
rules.
Money off. Yeah, like, fuck, what is this? What are we doing here?
See, it's, I don't know. See, we don't have rules. I've let everyone promote their show on our Facebook. The only thing I don't want you promoting is fucking handbags, boots, and shit like that. I do delete.
Now, hold on a second now. If you don't listen to the show, don't just come on our shit just promoting your stuff.
No, I don't know if they are, but you know what? I'm just not going to do that right now. I'm not going to start taking people's shit down. You want to promote your show? I don't give a shit. I'm not.
He's speaking for himself. I'm saying fuck that. Fuck that. With a capital F, man. Fuck that. If you listen to the show, or you're at least, you know, active on the Facebook, or you contribute somehow, but don't just come on here once a week just to drop your shit and not click on anything or do anything, you know? That's just, because, you know, that's pretty shitty. Like, I don't do that. I've never done that. I've never went on other podcasts, you know, websites and stuff and dropped our links. I've never done that. I think it's pretty shitty to do, actually.
Yeah, I would, but I don't know. I'm afraid to get a six paragraph message that has rules on it.
Right. Well, that was a wrestling group, so it, you know, it would make sense if we posted there. But
yeah. You
know?
Well,
and the funny thing is, I asked like for permission. You know, I asked the guy if I could, and then he sent me the fucking. So just imagine if I actually did post it without asking. That shit would have been. I would have probably got death threats.
Oh, you probably should have just done it then. Fuck it.
I don't care.
Nothing to lose, man. Nothing to fucking lose, Shaheen. Sometimes you got to put your fucking balls on the chopping block, my friend. Watch the knife go down.
It's all good, man. I'll just get Gucci, man.
Okay. All right. That's fine.
He'll come out with the guns blasting.
Yeah. There you go. That would be funny, though, to have a show that just sit there and kiss WWE's ass. I guarantee there's one out there. There has got to be a complete WWE kiss-ass show.
That are serious or fucking around?
I would say probably serious.
I'm sure there is that, but I'm saying if we make it a gimmick to just kind of just fuck with people, yeah, that'd be amazing. That'd be amazing. Take calls from like the most like angriest people, like myself. Like if I didn't know and this podcast existed, I would go nuts if I see these guys. I would hate them.
Oh, gosh.
We should just make a heel turn and turn into WWE fanboys.
It would be fun. That would be. People wouldn't understand how we can do both, though.
Yeah, we should do that. We do one real one where we shit on them, and do one where we're doing gimmicks. We just right. pretty much.
You know what? I'll just do the Todd Chrisley voice. I'll just go out there and go, listen, I love this WWE. It is great.
There you go, man.
But I don't understand why they wear so many clothes.
Oh, man. Well, dude, like, the product is, like, fantastic. Like, I think 2015 could be, like, a cool year, man.
These things are the best.
I mean, to be honest, like, we're pretty big WWE fans. Like, John Cena, like, dude, it's, like, my fucking hero. I fucking love that guy, dude. Like, totally.
Can't believe these divas. They're so gorgeous.
Yeah.
They should just be models or something.
This is honestly probably how WWE fans talk. You know, so. Sorry if I'm offending you guys, the WWE universe.
I just offended half of Dallas. I don't give a shit.
That was a sarcastic apology. I don't really mean it.
Oh, who cares? Anyone who's listened to any other episode knows we're fucking around anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or yeah. Are we?
I don't know. That's a mystery.
Oh, or are we? Man, I had a... Oh, did I not put that one in there? I missed that one. All right, no big deal.
You asshole.
Oh, wait, hold on. I do have it.
Cool. Well, it's kind of late now.
Yeah, it is. I'm just going to put it in here for the later, if you know what I mean.
This guy botched his spot.
I didn't know I had it. I got it. Remember I said I needed a dramatic sound for us. We never had one. Now we
have. Nice. That's news to me. So breaking news, we have dramatic sounds effects now.
We
sound
do.
Sound effects, not sound effects, I guess.
Breaking news.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh, she liked that one.
God damn.
You like that all one.
Right. All right. We're rocking and rolling tonight. Yeah. Sound bites, you know.
Yeah.
We got the Fanboy Club podcast starting soon. That's what we should call it, the Fanboy Club.
Oh, yeah. God. We're going to get killed.
Dude, we'd probably get hired by the WWE. We'd probably be on the network by next week.
That'd be the scary thing. We'd get hired and we'd be like, did we not?
That would be so funny.
We're characters.
Dude, that would be so funny, man. That would be amazing. We should do that. Get hired by the WWE from being fanboys. Go up there and beat them at their own games. Hey, man, that was just a gimmick. I don't really like this shit. Are you serious? I don't fuck with this guy. John Cena?
Then we'll go. Guy. Then we'll do our real show from when we get hired.
Oh, my God. That would be amazing. Do it from the headquarters. That would be fucking amazing. That would be amazing.
That would. Yeah.
We should make this happen. Vince McMahon, hire us for a week, please.
Oh, God. We would be so fired. I'd be so... Yeah. I'd be in heaven for one show. I'd do it.
McMahon would probably like it. We'd probably just stay hired.
Probably.
They probably just toss us a lot of money that we probably wouldn't be able to turn down. Just stay there. Yeah. Then eventually we'd be like Michael Cole and Jerry Lawler.
Listen, say this, bro. Private jet. Do whatever you want.
There you go, man. Private jets.
There you go. Up. Very nice tattoo picture in the chat room.
Tattoo ass alert. Ass tattoo alert.
I didn't say it was an ass tattoo.
Oh, well, shit. Oh, Jesus.
It's not an ass tattoo.
That's scary. Now, can we discuss this for a second, please?
If you give
in the chat room, in the chat room, somebody has posted a vagina tattoo, a vag tat, right? Now, this vag tat consists of a goddamn demon, and the demon makes the vagina. Like, the demon's mouth is the vagina. Now, my question to you is, how is this attractive? What man would want to put their penis in a demon's mouth? That is scary. It might be the scariest thing I've ever seen in my life, to be, you know. Weird, dude.
I'd do it.
I mean, I probably would just out of curiosity. Because I'm sure it would look cool. Like, the mouth would probably be close enough and stuff when you're pounding it. So it would probably look cool.
I mean, let's face it, it's not going to catch fire or anything.
Right.
I mean, if she's hot and she's got a demon on her badge, well, there's something, you know, you can pass this.
Badge tats, I don't know, man. I don't know if I'm a big fan of the badge tats.
I've actually seen that one many times, actually, believe it or not. I think that's in one of my files from back in the day. That's an old one.
Wow. Oh, I'm scared to see that pussy nowadays, man. That pussy probably looks gross.
That probably does by now, but
that's a nasty ass pussy.
I don't have that on here.
Well, you got it now. That's a nasty ass pussy.
There you go. I can cut that.
Bang.
All right. Well, I guess we should start getting into John Cena Appreciation Night.
Yeah, let's all appreciate him.
So let's get into Raw.
Well, let's summarize it.
Yeah,
as we always do, I guess, right?
Yeah, it's pretty much what we do. Started out with, God, this was horrible. Authority comes out. Do you remember?
Yes, I do. Seth Rollins basically came out, and Authority wanted to, you know, well, everybody was out, as mm-hmm. a matter of fact. And it was interesting to see the Ascension and the Divas are pretty much the only people standing outside the ring. But I guess it's like a respect thing since they're like new. I guess they got to stand outside the ring.
We'll get into the Ascension in a minute here.
It's kind of sexist, though, isn't it? Just toss all the Divas outside, except for Natty.
Well, let's face it. You wouldn't see them in between all the guys in the ring. And they're there for eye candy, so I kind of understand what they're doing.
Well, what about Natty?
Was she in the ring?
She's just as small as everybody else.
She's
not probably, smaller.
She was probably holding Tyson Kidd's hand, though, so that's different.
Yeah, I don't know. I think Paige was inside also. I guess it was just all the jobber divas, like, you know.
Oh, probably all the, yeah, like the ones that no one knows anymore.
Like the ones that I just completely paused on and almost stuttered because I can't remember any of their names.
The ones when I mention their matches, all we get is.
Yep, there you go. That's what there you we get. Go.
Okay, so yeah, the whole roster was in the ring. Go ahead.
Yeah, Seth Rollins comes out and basically the Authority wants to thank him for bringing them back. So, they're going to give him a title shot. And when is that going to be? At the Rumble. So, we're going to get a three-way dance. I'm sorry, that's... What are they... Triple threat. Is that what they call it? Triple threat?
It's... Yeah, I think they call it a three-way dance in Lucha.
Boxman froze up on me. I think it's a triple threat in the WWE.
It is.
I know... That's what I've been kind of used to.
Yeah, you're right. You're 100%
right. You're freezing up on me, bruh.
Oh, you are correct. Correct. Right.
Yeah, I can't hear.
That's because you just froze up on me. That's why you can't hear me, because you froze up on me. Don't blame me freezing up when you're freezing up, too.
I don't know, man. I couldn't hear bro, man.
Don't blame me freezing up, bro, when you're freezing up, bro. All right, hey, bro?
Hey, bro. I don't know. I don't know whose end it is, but I couldn't hear bro, man. But anyway... Look,
I blame you too, bro. Let's keep going.
All good, man. We can play that blame game. But anyway, Seth Rollins comes out. They want to appreciate him, so they give him a title shot. three-way dance, triple threat, whatever you want to call it, Brock Lesnar, John Cena, Seth Rollins, triple threat, Royal Rumble, January 25th. I'm excited. I'll be there. Are you excited for this? Because, I don't know, I kind of actually wish they would have just left it as a... I don't know. Let me think about this for a minute. You give me your opinion, but I think I actually prefer it as a triple threat, although I can't see Rollins main event in WrestleMania. I'll go ahead and say that, but as far as a match, it's more exciting because I didn't really want to see Lesnar and Cena again, especially live.
Yeah, I think this definitely at least breaks the monotony of Lesnar-Cena 4, which is really what this is. Actually, it's more than 4. It's 4 recently. I think this is like Brock-Cena 209. But at least it breaks the monotony a little bit. Rollins, got to remember, he's got that briefcase, could cash in. So you never know what could happen. It does add a few more what-ifs to the match, which I guess in wrestling that does, I guess, make it better.
Now, since we always pretty much bash the WWE, I'm going to go ahead and speak for myself, but I'm sure you probably agree. But we have to give them credit. They really built up a couple people this last couple of months to kind of make Royal Rumble exciting. Like last year, we pretty much knew it was either going to be Daniel Bryan or Batista. And Daniel Bryan wasn't there, so it's like, all right, well, obviously it's Batista. This year, we have a couple different candidates, and that's exciting. And also, for WrestleMania, we kind of don't know who's going to be the champion, you know, because they actually saved the Money in the Bank briefcase. So that's, and you know, Seth Rollins is a guy that I think they're really invested in. So I wouldn't really be surprised if they actually push him to the top, which is I don't think he's ready yet. But again, it has a surprise factor, which I appreciate. That makes wrestling exciting. I don't want to know, you know, I really don't want to know, which I don't know really. So I'm excited, you know. Could be Dolph Ziggler, it could be Seth Rollins, it could be John Cena, Orton, Reigns, Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose. There's a ton of guys.
I don't know about all those guys, but like I said, yeah. Look, it definitely adds the what ifs and the who could it be factor. The briefcase does add a little more to the match too, knowing he could cash in if the shit hits the fan, he could just cash in, so who knows. But I don't know. It's going to be a good match. So we have that match, and we have Daniel Bryan and Roman Reigns in the Rumble. Who else?
Who else is in the Rumble? Is that what you're asking?
Yeah, you don't know. You don't know who's in the Rumble because there's only two guys that are announced for the Rumble right now.
Yeah, that's kind of weird, right? Well, you can bet your ass the El Matadores are going to be there.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah, Matadores are going to be there. The little midget bull. That's exciting.
The midget bull.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, yeah. Shit, yeah. Titus O'Neil, he will
be Titus there. O'Neil.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yep, exciting, right? I'm sure The Miz is going to be there.
The Miz?
Yeah, he needs that. He needs.
I think it is an oh hell yeah, hell no.
Yeah, he needs that with his fake ass Hollywood self. But, yeah, that's exciting. Titus O'Neil, Matadors. I mean, fuck yeah.
I don't know. We'll see. Luckily, it's only a 30 man this year, so we'll see what happens. But
apparently, actually, Sting is going to be there. So that's. That's probably exciting, right?
Yeah, Sting. Yeah, he came out, a couple months ago? Yeah,
great. I'm sorry, the vigilante Sting.
Oh, yeah, and yeah, the lunatic fringe.
Vince McMahon corrected me in my headphones. I'm sorry. What was that, sir? I know, I appreciate my job, sir. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Absolutely. I didn't know if you wanted me to say it again. I'll say it from now on. Vigilante Sting. He may be at the WWE Royal Rumble. So again, Vigilante Sting.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. Much better. Good job. Good job. So yeah, we got a triple threat, and then what's his name? Triple H announces a match coming up for the Intercontinental Championship between Bad News Barrett and Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah.
New champion. We have a new champion coming out of this match. Bad News Barrett.
I don't know about this one.
Does it really matter?
It doesn't really matter, but I don't know.
This belt doesn't matter anymore. I'm sorry. I hate to just be flat out about it, but honestly, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't. I mean, look at NXT. They have how many belts do they have? 3-4?
Yeah.
Yeah, but at least they kind of mean something, right?
Yeah, I guess. I don't know.
They've only had like 3 or 4 champions ever.
Yeah, I mean, I wish they would do something with this belt, man. I mean, there's so many guys that held this belt that never held the champion, the world champion belt, but held the IC title, and they're legends either way. And now this belt is like, I mean, you may as well be carrying around a slammy.
Yeah. It may be worse than that.
Well, I wasn't sure if you were going to agree, but I guess you do, so we can go on from that.
Yeah, but they kind of made Ziggler look strong, you know, because, you know, with the Chief attack and all that stuff. So I guess they're still keeping him strong.
They didn't kill him, but I don't know. He might need to, I don't know, his selling might be his detriment. He sells too well. That might be bad for him.
Bad because he's going to get injured, or?
Bad because he sells everything like he's dead, and yeah, he's going to not last long because of it. I don't know, man. I just think he should chill a little bit. Let them sell for him more. Fuck that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm being picky. Maybe I'm old. Who knows? Maybe all three.
No, I like it. I like him.
Yeah. But new champion coming out of this match. Bad News Barrett takes the belt, and he's got bad news for ya.
I think Ziggler he needs to grow like a beard or something though, man. He looks too much of a like a pussy.
He does look too babyface, but yeah, he could get some.
He doesn't even look babyface, dude. He looks like a pussy. There's a difference. Like you can be a babyface, but you don't.
Know what he needs.
He looks like a fucking, like, I don't know. I don't want to say it because I don't want to.
You know, since he looks like a pussy, he should get a demon tattoo on his face.
There you go.
And the mouth would be right.
I don't want to know.
All right, I'll stop right there.
Oh, good God.
Come on, you knew I was going to go there, didn't you?
Yeah, absolutely.
You didn't think I was that bad?
This fucking guy. But, yeah, man.
In high school, by the way.
What was that?
That was my nickname in high school.
This fucking guy?
Pretty much.
This fucking guy.
where they would just shake their head and go, fucking Dave.
This fucking guy.
The fucking Dave. What is he doing now?
Man. But,
yeah. Good stuff.
What am I going to say? God damn it.
I think we were going to the next match.
All right, go ahead.
Because I think I accidentally cut you off and lost your train of thought. I don't know. We were talking about Bad News Barrett, next champion.
Yeah. Ziggler. Just, I don't know, dude. Grow a fucking beard. Dye your hair or something. I don't know. I don't know.
I'm telling you, man. He needs whiskey and cigars.
He does. Same with Rollins. He needs a new voice box.
Rollins has tried to man up a little bit. I think Rollins actually sounds a bit, at least Rollins sounds like a heel, because he sounds like a weed. I think
on, John.
Is good.
Come on, John.
I don't want, come on, dude.
Oh, it's good on him. It might not work on someone else, like, you know what I mean. I don't know. Like,
don't get me wrong, I love Rollins. I think he's great in the ring. One of the best sellers, you know, best, yeah, high flyers, technical, whatever you want to say. He's really good in the ring. Great in the ring, matter of fact. But I don't know. I don't even think he's bad on the mic. They give him the mic for too long. I think he gets lost in the shuffle when they give him the microphone for too long, and they give him a script, and it's like, you know, the guy can't act very well. Maybe you just, you know, give him some pointers, which we know they're not going to do, so this is what you get as a result of that. So, I don't know, man. I enjoy him definitely in the ring. I just wish they would maybe give him the microphone for 5 minutes instead of 25 minutes.
Not going to disagree with that. I mean, do they give him sometimes too much? Yeah, but, it, you know, he's definitely improved, in my opinion. I'm not going to everybody, but I think he's improved on the mic, and he's gotten way more, like I said, weaselly heelish, which is what his character is supposed to be. So I don't know. I'm going to give him a little bit of credit for the work he's doing on the mic.
No, I think the character is great. Like you said, being a weasel and, you know, sneaking behind people's backs and attacking them from behind and doing all this stuff, like what he was doing with Edge. All that stuff is great. I love it. I just, you know, the microphone is just too much. But then again, you know, last year we were wondering if Seth Rollins was going to get lost in the shuffle, and here we are saying Seth Rollins is getting the microphone for too long. So that pretty much sums it all up. It's unbelievable.
Yeah. I think everybody just pretty much thought it was going to be Roman Reigns and the other two guys were going to be lost in the shuffle. Yeah, like you said. So thank God they're not, and all three of them are. Three of them are up and coming. One of them being shoved down our throats more than others. But anyway,
well, you can thank Daniel Bryan, CM Punk, and Roman Reigns for getting injured and leaving. Well, that's the only reason essentially why Seth Rollins and Dean Ambrose are not on main event. You know, wrestling with Titus O'Neil and shit.
Timing, it's all timing, and if that's what it took. What is it they say? Everything happens for a reason?
Yeah.
So.
They were in the right place at the right time, my friend.
Sometimes that's what it takes, man. Timing, timing, timing. Most of life is about it.
Absolutely. Well, let's not waste any more time, and let's go ahead and get on to the next match.
Ooh, yeah, the Ascension.
All right. We're going to have to talk about that for a couple minutes.
Okay. I hope you're going to get into the promo.
Yes.
Okay, and in case you hadn't heard it, I had it ready to go, just in case, because it was only a couple seconds. It wasn't long at all, but yeah, the promo. You there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. I can play it if you want me to.
Yeah, I said please. I don't know if you heard me or not.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm grinding up something.
Oh, it's wonderful.
I'm listening. I just didn't hear that part.
Well, yeah, go ahead and play this awful promo that's going to segue us into bitching about the Ascension.
Yeah, it's a couple seconds before it, so here we go.
Throughout the history of WWE, there have been many so-called dominant tag teams.
What?
Just Axe and Smash of Demolition.
Mm-hmm.
What?
We'll destroy Demolition.
What?
Or there's the Road Warrior.
What?
We'll throw them right off the road. Hey, yo, Vic. What's the old saying? What a rush. More like, oh, what a joke.
Wow.
Oh, boy.
The Ascension.
Yeah.
That's bad.
Oh, wait.
To the Wasteland.
Welcome to the Wasteland. There you go.
I do like that, though. I like that saying. Welcome to the Wasteland. I like that.
All right. That's not horrible. But let's be honest here. Was that completely disrespectful, number one? Number two, you guys look like a couple of fags in your makeup. So, you know, that's all I'm going to say there. But, you know.
Oh, those guys are fags!
That's right. And your fucking, your little eye of whores on your eyes and your fake little widow's peak with the, God damn it, they look like shit. I don't like them. I'll tell you what, you say what you want about Demolition. you don't fuck with the Road Warriors, motherfucker. That's a line.
No, don't even mess with the Demolition. I like the Demolition.
Fuck Demolition. Fucking
what? God. I like the Demolition, dude. Get out of here.
Fuck Demolition.
God, get out of here, man. Come on. Demolition was good, man.
Demolition were fucking Road Warriors ripoffs.
They were, but they were still good, man. I mean, you know what?
Yeah. Yeah, you probably like the Repo Man, too. Gotcha.
No, but I didn't mind the Repo Man. I mean, dude, it was fucking 93. I mean, you know.
Yeah. And you know what?
We had fucking, you know, the Matador, and we had Warlord, and the Bushwhackers, and fucking Doink the Clown, and Yokozuna, and Papa Shango, and all, you know, that's what, Skinner, you know, that's what it was.
Yeah.
But honestly, and I know I complain about bad wrestling, I don't care what anybody says, dude, 93 and 94, I thoroughly enjoyed it. 95, I don't know about. 93 and 94, I loved it. I mean, 93 especially. I thought 93 was great.
I didn't mind it, I guess. But I just don't like these two guys together. I do not. They're horrible.
Forgot about them.
And like Kevin just said here in the chat room, JBL buried him too right afterwards. He goes, those guys couldn't carry the Road Warriors bags. Look, I was thinking the same thing. But don't say it on commentary. Aren't you supposed to kind of put these guys over a little bit?
Well, that's what I was going to say. That's what really just confused me, because I agree. It was really disrespectful, right?
We
can agree on that, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right. So if you're going to disrespect these guys, right, and one is it has passed away already, so
that's
if you're going to – okay, so if you are already going to disrespect these guys, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why? So these, you're sacrificing the Road Warriors essentially to put these guys over, correct? So what's the point if you're going to do that? At least actually put them over. What's the point of having a 5-second match which puts them over? That's fine, but why have all the commentators just bury them? That just completely just made no sense. It gained nothing. They pretty much just shat on the Legion of Doom, the Road Warriors, Demolition, all those tag teams, and they got buried pretty much 3 seconds later. And one of the jobbers that actually faced them is a good guy, Parviz Memori. He's a wrestler out of Texas, actually.
Yeah, I saw you posted that, and I liked him on Facebook because I saw that he was a Texas guy. So yeah, I did. I saw that. That's pretty cool. But
I don't know, dude.
I really thought it was, you know, someone said on Facebook today it was classless. It was. It was classless. It was tasteless. It was. And I mean, you're mentioning three teams. Oh, you young guys can beat up some old guys from the 80s. Is that saying much?
Right. And they can't even do that, dude. They're skinny. I mean, the one guy is pretty much skinny. The other guy is just sloppy.
Then, the fucking Connor looks over and, yo, Vic. And Vic didn't even say anything. He didn't even look at him. He was like, oh, me. I'm Vic. Oh, I forgot.
It's weird, man. I mean, don't get me wrong. I don't completely hate them. And I kind of appreciate them because we needed some new tag teams. But this was bad. This was bad. Like you said, this was tasteless. This was disrespectful. It was just ignorant, you know? It made no sense. I wonder how Animal felt about this. You know, I'm sure that, you know, somebody's going to ask him sometime soon. But
well, I know one person felt pretty shitty about it. That was Lance Storm, who shut off the show after that promo. So he says. Lance Storm has quit watching Raw for the past 5 years. Let's not forget that.
Yeah, I don't believe that. That guy is the biggest critic of Raw.
He really is. I mean, he really wants his show. I don't know. Maybe he should do a promotion because I don't know. But yeah, I posted that he got all pissed off and he shut the show, and I agree it was disrespect. I mean, I didn't turn off the show. I just said, God, that was horrible, disrespectful.
Yeah. You know,
bring up three teams you'll never be able to have a match with. One of them's dead. You know, two, the other guys are too old, and Who else did they bring up?
No, that's it. Actually, they only brought up the Road Warriors, but the previous week they brought up Demolition.
I thought they brought up they brought up Demolition on this promo too. So,
yeah, those two teams.
I just don't like. I mean, there's no reason to talk about. Don't bury Road Warriors. Those.
You know what they should do? Bring back the Powers of Pain because they're still active wrestlers. I mean, Warlord and Barbarians, they still wrestle. Just bring them in for one match and just have them completely bury the Ascension and just fire all these guys and just
yeah. Warlord is still jacked. My buddy works out of the gym with him.
Yeah, I saw him at WrestleCon 2 years ago. Yeah, he pretty much looks the same.
Yeah, he's still pretty jacked up. So
weird. He's one of those guys that clearly took a lot of fucking steroids and he looks fine. I mean,
some guys can handle them better than others.
I guess, man. I guess he wasn't taking the horse steroids. He was taking sheep steroids or something. I don't know.
He was taking the good roids, I guess. But
I guess, man. But, yeah. So, I don't know, man. Ascension. I don't know. You're probably going to see them on Pro Wrestling Syndicate soon.
I could see them on TNA soon, maybe.
Yeah, there you go.
I just didn't like it one bit. I'm sorry, but
do you like them at all? I mean, aside from bad pro, not at all. Did you like them on NXT?
I did. I liked them on NXT. They didn't have this fucking fake ass gay makeup on.
Yeah, I mean the makeup is terrible. But honestly, don't they look smaller on the bigger platform?
They do.
Connor looks really small.
Connor looked like 30 pounds heavier in NXT. Maybe that ring is just tiny.
I get they do. They look really small on Raw, you know. And on NXT, I thought they were like decent size. I didn't think they were giants, but at least I thought they were passable. When I saw them on Raw, I was like, you know, this is pretty much Christopher Daniels on. You know, a couple beefsteaks and the other guys is just sloppy looking. He's not really big. You know? Bro, man.
Yo.
Right here.
Where? You cut out for a second. I'm so sorry.
All good, man. I was just saying that they look sloppy.
They do. They look horrible out there. And I don't know. They probably should have had a little more time. I know that Connor guy has had a lot of time in NXT. He should be a lot better than he is, but I don't know.
I don't think it's that, man. I think it's just a gimmick. I think it's just bad stuff.
BS, man.
Like the makeup. If they gave him better makeup and they told him not to be the Road Warriors and not wear fucking black and red mention the Road Warriors and all this, like... They would probably be passable.
Probably. I mean,
they could just make them like a badass tag team without, you know, making them this fucking... these giants and fucking barbaric guys coming out. Because they're not. They're not. They're just some random, regular-looking guys.
That's it. I mean, they're guys you could see at any gym, anywhere. Right.
You even see them at the gym, because they don't look like it.
I think Connor sticks out a little bit. I mean, he is a bigger guy, and he's got kind of a strange, like he said, a rat face look to him. So he does have a wrestler look to him. But I think the other guy is just, I mean, they basically replaced Bram with a guy who looked almost like Bram. It's weird.
Now, if Bram was in that tag team, I think it would be 100% better.
I think so. And I actually did watch when Bram was in it, and yeah, he did make it better.
Yeah. I bet, man. Bram was fucking awesome in TNA. He was probably like the only guy I liked on the roster.
Yeah, I'm curious. Yeah, I'm definitely curious to see what TNA does tomorrow night, so I will be watching that tomorrow night.
Yeah. By the way, doesn't Victor kind of look like a, not a skinnier version, but like a smaller version of Ryback? Like his face, he looks like Ryback in the face.
I never noticed, but I'll have to look next time.
Yeah, check it out, man. He kind of resembles Ryback. Almost like they're brothers.
I'll take a peek.
Yeah. But next match, please.
Oh, hold on. Whoa, that is awesome. Anyway, yeah, next match.
What's awesome? Let me check this out.
Yeah, check that out while I'm talking. Oh, then we got this Roman Reigns. Did you see this?
I like this. See, this is what we're talking about.
Oh, yeah, that's very
nice. He posed more like this. I don't need to see a demonic vagina, you know? This is nice.
Great back tattoo. Gorgeous back tattoo.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Beautiful. Yeah, absolutely. Of course that's what you're talking about.
Beautiful Asian tattoo.
So, did you know the... Did you hear the rumble? I must have cut out on you, Shaheen.
Yeah, you're back.
All right. Did you hear the promo Roman Reigns did?
I did. it definitely raised an eyebrow, and I'm going to go ahead and come up with another conspiracy theory, okay?
I've got it if you want to hear it.
Please. Yes, please play that.
I think I've got it lit up. Hold on.
And keep Superman in mind.
Okay, yeah.
Welcome my guest, Roman Reigns.
Is this loud enough?
Yeah, it's fine.
With everything that has led up to this moment, what can we expect?
I don't know what to expect. Big Show, he's 7 feet tall, 450 pounds, and all of that is coming for me. But I do know what he can expect.
Oh, God.
He can expect a man that's faster than a speeding bullet. Bam!
Ooh. Wow. A
man over a tall building in a single bound.
Ooh.
A man so powerful, more powerful than a locomotive.
What?
A Big Show can expect. A Big Show can expect. Me. Believe that.
Oh, believe that. Yeah.
Alrighty then.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly what I was going to say. All right then.
Okay.
Okie dokie. Anyway, now can I go ahead and say this for a second? I think I absolutely believe that Vince McMahon has a hard-on for Superman.
I think he likes the superhero thing, but this guy...
It's Superman. It's just Superman. He loves Superman.
It probably is, but this guy is definitely the next John Cena.
Absolutely. That's what I was going to say, because John Cena resembles Superman, correct?
In a way, but I mean, the way...
Cena. You
see the looks this guy gives. This guy knows the chicks are out there watching him, and he just gives these little... Paltry looks.
He thinks he's LL Cool J, man. He licks his lips every time he says "believe that" and all that.
Yeah, it's pretty bad, dude. He's But that promo right there had me scratching my head, going, "What the fuck did I just hear?" Who? Can you? Okay. This show was. Technically rewritten at 3:00 from what I read in the reports, whether it was or wasn't.
We can tell.
Even if it wasn't, who sat there and said, well, he uses a Superman punch, right? Let's do a Superman promo.
Yeah.
And someone actually looked at him and said, great idea.
Probably Vince.
Okay, maybe those are the two guys that should have a podcast kissing WWE's ass.
Yeah.
God damn, that was horrible.
Dude, I'm telling you, man, they have an obsession with Superman. It's weird.
It is weird. It was very odd, but I don't know.
Do you think Vince McMahon has a Superman tattoo?
If it is, he may.
Like the WWE logo?
He may.
In the middle?
Probably both. It's probably the WWE logo and, like, it's probably the WWE logo morphed into a Superman logo.
Yeah.
Probably. Yeah.
Let's go and get WWE tattoos to show our loyalty to the fanboy podcast.
No, we're not going to do that.
We could. Sure, loyalty to the WWE universe that we love so much.
Yeah, my luck, they would change their logo a day later.
They would. If anything, I would definitely get the old school logo, man. I would never put that new shit on me.
Yeah.
I would never put any of it on me, but if I were to, I would definitely put the old school.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, at least that's something people recognize and understand.
No one's talking. Even the Attitude Era one, that one was kind of shitty.
Yeah, but not horrible.
Yeah, I never liked it. I actually think the one now is better than the Attitude Era one, man. That one was kind of really shitty, actually.
I don't care much for the run right now, but it's not that bad, I guess.
Yeah. It's just it's nice and plain and neat. The other one was just, I guess it fit the era, though, you know?
Yeah, it did. It was the sloppy era.
The sloppy era.
So
wrestlers showing up fucking coked up, wrestling all sloppy and shit.
It's where they should be now. It'd be fucking better. I mean, maybe Roman Reigns could use a fucking Tutorutsky in the back.
Yeah, they had all the sloppy rats in the back.
That's what they need.
Giving sloppy drops.
Fucking ring rats, blowjobs, and coke.
Yeah, man. Sloppy ring rats giving sloppy blowjobs. There you go.
Damn right. Right during the promos. Like, just promo from, like, the neck up, and just they're just down there fucking getting blown during a promo.
Maybe they should do that with Roman Reigns.
Jim Morrison.
Do that with Roman Reigns. Maybe that'll, like, relax the guy a little bit.
In style.
Yeah. You tuned out for a second. I couldn't hear what you said.
Yeah. They should do that shit Jim Morrison style.
There you go, man.
Just fucking Rain sitting there going, believe, oh, dad, oh.
Believe that.
Yeah, believe, who heave that, okay.
Fucking Roman Reigns, man.
That, okay.
I don't think people are going to take a liking to him when he comes to Philly, man. I think that guy's going to get booed a lot.
I guess we'll see, man. But
I don't really think he deserves, but yeah, we'll see. But what was next?
We will see. Well, after that honey of a promo, we got Roman Reigns and Big Show. Reigns won this match by DQ when Show hit him with his ring steps. And then Reigns comes in and spears the stairs right down on Big Show's head.
Yeah, it looked like it hurt.
If you watch the replay, he really placed it there with his left hand. His hand was through the hole, and he brought it down.
Yeah. I missed most of the match, so I kind of...
How, after that promo, could you not have been completely enthused to watch that match? I don't get it.
Sorry.
Man, Shaheen, I don't know about you sometimes, man.
Yeah, man, I know. It was so exciting. I know it's my fault. I apologize.
He was faster than a speeding bullet. Pew!
I let down the WWE universe once again. I'm sorry, folks.
That's all right. The good thing is, according to Vince McMahon, they won't remember it in 3 seconds.
That's true. We don't remember shit, according to them.
Nope. Don't remember nothing, so. All right, there was that match. Steps fell on his head. And then we...
You all right, man? You're dying over there. Ladies and gentlemen, Boxman just died.
No, I'm here.
Oh, all right. No, never mind. He didn't die.
No, I'm here.
Good shit.
I'm getting a cold, and it's getting worse as it gets later, because it's just starting, so. I'm getting more stuffed up.
Oh, my God. Stop this. Hold on. Please, what? Please. Stop.
What did I do?
People have to stop doing this shit, man. They got to stop this.
What did I miss? Hold on.
No. All right. People are posting that Dolph Ziggler has signed with Impact Wrestling. And no, this is not from kayfabenews.com. This is not a joke. People are believing this shit.
Okay, did you see the one with Kali? It was the same bullshit today. Someone posted one of Kali, and it's so far it has like 30-something But I did say that, oh, Khali could replace Taz on commentary.
They'd be better. I'm not even talking about like this. The comments. I'm reading the comments, and people are like really arguing that, you know, no, Ziggler's really signed to TNA. Like, no. The WWE angle was you know, it's he's not fired, you idiots. He's, he can't. Oh, wrestling fan. Is it?
Where is it?
It's just on one of these fucking message boards. I can post the picture on
Because there's one on I'll just say there's one on In Your Head about Khali.
No, this one is not Ziggler.
Dolph Ziggler. Well, they're gonna put Ryback, and I'm sure Ryback will be the next one, and Rowan.
Yeah, I'm sure.
All right. First of all, if they're using their names from WWE, it's fake.
Exactly. Like I can't believe people, man. Like I can't believe people are really defending this shit, saying that they actually got fired. That really just that baffles my mind. I don't.
Well, they've got to. I mean, the Rumble's in 2 weeks, so they've got to be back next week.
No, that's going to be the surprise entrance. Fucking Ziggler, Ryback, Randy Orton, Eric Rowan, and probably Rob Van Dam because we're in Philly for ECW.
Motherfucker, kiss my ass.
You're not Vince McMahon, dude. What the fuck?
Unfucking believable. Oh, well.
Yeah?
People are gullible.
Yeah, this is just idiotic. I don't want
it. Yeah, it is. So, anyway, people will believe anything, obviously. So,
this is amazing, though, that people actually believe this. That amazes me. Oh, there is Rowan once and Ryback once. Amazing.
Oh, there you go. You knew those were coming out.
Amazing.
All three of them at TNA tomorrow night.
All three of them.
I'll tell you.
On TNA.
If they showed up, I would give TNA fucking major props.
Oh, they wouldn't because they're on their contract. But yeah, that would be awesome. But yeah.
I would love it, but no, it ain't happening. It ain't happening. I know it. You know it. Anyone with a medium-sized brain knows it.
Yeah, people are crazy, man.
Yeah, so.
People are insane. But yeah. Next match, please.
Next match. Next match.
Gotta finish with this damn Raw.
I told you, Natalia beat Nikki Bella, and then we get, speaking of Eric Rowan, Luke Harper and Eric Rowan with Jamie Noble and Joey Mercury as the special guest.
Yeah, they gotta stop giving away this match and doing all these fuck finishes. And yes, that's a word now. But I don't know, man. You know. I like both of these guys, so, you know, I was excited for the match, but, I mean, the match wasn't great. Didn't really get, you know.
But there's
not any time.
There's no time. There's no build. There's no, I mean, okay, I understand the build is they were partners one time. There's your build. What?
Right.
Okay. Thank you. There was nothing. It's just, hey, look, these guys are going to hate each other because they used to be together. What? Yep, I'm just an idiot.
Dude, now, hold on 1 second.
Hell.
I absolutely forgot what I was going to say.
Awesome.
Amazing.
See, we do have no memory. Vince, you know, Vince might have a point.
We are the stereotype, man.
You know what, Vince? You've got a point, pal.
Vince is always correct, man. We are idiots. We don't remember shit. And Cesaro can't talk.
We have no man, and oh my god, Cesaro is Swiss. Holy shit.
And there's apparently 4 ropes. But yeah, Vince McMahon is correct.
Vince really does have this shit down, doesn't he?
He does. He does. Yeah, we just don't get it. He's so much of a genius. He's just beyond our mind. We just don't get it. Just flies over our tiny little brains.
Vince knows us better than we know us.
True. It's true. That's why he called himself God once.
That, I'm bigger than God.
Oh, dude, I felt so. I'm not religious or anything, but I felt so uncomfortable watching that. That was just weird.
That's when I took a little break.
It was too fucking weird, dude. It's just, you know, there's a point where it's like, all right, man, this is like, I don't know. I don't even want to really get into that because that's a whole.
Yeah, we need
an hour conversation.
Yeah. So.
Anyway, next match.
Yeah. Anyway, Luke Harper beat Rowan when Noble counted a really fast count. It was a bullshit match.
It's a fuckboy finish.
Yeah. Right.
I'm just gonna add fuck to everything. Fuckboy finish. Fuck finish.
That's pretty much how Raw's been going lately. Goddamn Russo. Ambulance match is next. Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose.
I thought this was awesome. Probably the only thing I enjoyed. So.
I did, yeah. But how many times do we have to see this match?
Hopefully no more, but.
Okay, how many more gimmicks can this match have?
A steel cage match?
Didn't this actually started in a steel cage, so.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
Finish it there, but. Holograms. Can't do steel cages. You get holograms in steel cages.
And that was never explained. I'd really like to know what that was about, but. We won't get that.
Don't do that.
Yeah, we won't get that.
No, it'll be like 5 years down the road, and they'll be like, oh, we need to explain this.
Yeah.
Let's just tell them it was Hornswoggle.
Everything is Hornswoggle.
See? You get it.
Everything is Hornswoggle.
It was all Hornswoggle.
Everything.
Oh, God, that's fucked up.
Yeah. But I enjoyed this match, man. I thought it was some good action. They brawled everywhere. They did a spot with the ambulance for Dean Ambrose. And, you know, he's got to do a different spot because he always does the elbow drop onto the table now. I mean, I've seen that spot with just Bray Wyatt alone about 16 times in the last fucking month.
Yeah.
So it's like, all right, I know where this is going. I just saw it on, like, SmackDown. I saw it on Raw. I saw it on Main Event. I saw it on the pay-per-view. I saw the replays. I saw it on the app. I saw it on the network. I saw it on your website. Put it on a t-shirt. I'll buy it. Just stop doing the same shit, please.
Give me something new. So you haven't seen it is what you're saying?
I haven't seen it. No, give me more.
Okay. I got you. All right.
Thanks, man. So next week, Bray Wyatt, Dean Ambrose, 2 out of 3 falls.
First 2 out of 3 elbow drops only.
Elbow drops only. What a great match that would be.
All right. Anyway.
How cool would that be, though? Like, you can't do anything but elbow drops. So, like, how do you even attack the guy, you know? Like, the first guy to attack. What, do you just both go on the rope and just start diving off the top and just whoever hits who first?
You'd have to jump and hope he didn't move and hit him with the elbow.
Yeah, which would never happen, so I don't know. That's tough. Somebody should do that.
Yeah, not us. Anyway.
I'm down, man. I'd like to try that out.
You would. Oh, shit.
Backyard wrestling used to be great.
Yeah, until lawsuits happened.
Well, I mean, when it's your friends. All
right. Anyway, we only got a couple.
Loyal friends. Loyal friends, not vaginas.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Not. Damn, another nice one.
What, the one with the ocean waves?
Yeah.
Yeah, zoom in. You can, like, zoom in inside her asshole. The picture has too many fucking megapixels.
That's
larger of a picture.
That's a great picture.
Yeah.
I do want to check that little piercing down there on the right.
I don't. I saw that. I'm not, dude. I'm not into, like, I don't know. I don't like goth girls.
I don't know what that.
You love it?
That's her. I think that's her left nipple, Anyway.
Do you like goth chicks?
Doesn't bother me one bit, man.
I mean, it doesn't bother me, but, like, that's not my preference, you know?
Yeah, I mean...
I don't know. Like, too many piercings and stuff, I don't know, I'm not into it.
Eh. Piercings never bothered me. Tattoos don't bother me. Piercings never bothered me.
I mean, tattoos don't really bother me. Too much of it is like, eh. But one or two here and there is fine. I can't really say much because I have a shitload myself, so who am I to talk, you know?
No big deal. Who cares?
Yeah, well.
You want to do, you fucks. All right. So, we've only got a few matches left, and then the glorious ending that we will get into. This match will take no time. We're probably going to say nothing about it. The Miz, Damian Mizdow with Alicia Fox against the Usos and Naomi.
I like how what's his name? The Miz is into like black chicks now. Is that his new gimmick?
I guess so.
I like that though. That's cool. I guess. I mean, is that a gimmick? Like, what the fuck?
I don't know. I mean, everybody. I mean, he's banging Maurice, so he can do what he wants anywhere. As far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I still don't know what she looks like. Let me go ahead and Google her.
She's amazing.
Why is she with this guy then?
Dude, he's either got like tons of FU money or he's just fucking packing in the fucking cock area. One of the two.
Probably not the second one.
Yeah, he must just have fucking, like, real, like...
She is. Like, gorgeous. Oh, why?
By the way, she has done Playboy.
Why this guy, though? I mean...
I don't know, but you can get nudies if you type in the old nude word afterwards.
But see, I'm weird, though. Like, perfect chicks like this, like, they don't really turn me on. Like, I like more of, like regular girls, you know? Like, good-looking, but, like regular. He's like 10 out of 10s, and
Yeah, she looks pretty good to me. And she's
she definitely does. I'm not saying she doesn't look good. I'm saying she looks too damn good, if you get what I'm saying. It sounds weird, but...
Oh, I got it. I get it.
Makes sense inside my brain.
Yeah, I get you. Anyway, The Miz pins Jimmy Uso with a roll-up.
You pinned Jim Ross? Is that what you're saying?
No, Jimmy Uso. I was about to say Jim Russo. I don't know why I was about to say Jim
Russo. You were saying Jim Ross. I was like, oh, shit, what did I miss?
Oh, goddamn roll-up. That's not a Sonic roll-up. Yeah. Sonic roll-up. Give me a peach tea while you're there.
he loves the peach tea, man. He's really trying to get that advertisement money.
Dude, he is so trying to get Sonic.
He's so bad. It's to the point it's awkward, you know? When you listen to it, it's like, all right, dude, you said it on the last, 35 episodes and you still haven't gotten them, it just looks desperate.
Yeah, you got a point.
I love this peach tea over here.
Yeah.
It's from Sonic, by the way, and you can go ahead and purchase that right now while you listen to this podcast. By the way, it's from Sonic, once again. It's the peach tea. Like, shut the fuck up, dude. I get it. I get it.
Yeah, exactly.
Put them behind closed doors, you know?
Yeah, and by the way,
email. You don't have to promote them for free to get their attention. It just looks desperate.
Yeah, by the way, you're going to hear silence while I take a sip of my Heineken Light.
You get that? Heineken Light. Heineken Light.
Right. Heineken Light. That was delicious.
Heineken Light. By the way, I'm drinking some Starbucks over here, so if Starbucks wants to, you know, give us some free coffee, we'd love to make a podcast strictly about Starbucks.
We're down for advertisers, yeah. Although I think that we'd have a chance with just a fucking Fleshlight, maybe. That's about the only thing I shot with. Okay.
Next match, please. Goddamn.
Next match. This was another match. Twice last night, they forgot to mention to competitors that it was a handicap match.
Oh yeah, this match was
yep. Seth Rollins and Kane against Ryback. Ryback's over, dude.
Oh, he's mega over. It's good. I'm happy for the guy, man. He's actually like a big wrestling fan.
I am too. And while we're on the subject of Ryback, I'm kind of...
No shit, man. We're doing a wrestling podcast. I hope you're a wrestling fan.
Yeah, exactly.
Shit, man. Well, I am too.
Yeah.
Well, Bachman, yeah. I am a wrestling fan also.
Yeah, I am too.
Didn't know. You are too. Great.
Yeah, I am too. But I'm glad to mention Ryback, though, because I finally heard that interview. I know it's from a few weeks ago, but I finally heard that Chris Jericho interview with him and Ryback.
Yeah.
He basically tells the whole story he told on Raw, but a lot more detail.
Yeah.
I like Ryback more after that interview, after hearing what... I mean, he loves and has a big passion for this business. He's obsessed with this business, with wrestling. Yeah. So
I love clips of it.
I love it. I thought after that, I kind of had a new respect for him after that interview. It was a good interview.
Did you see the hate that WWE got for giving Ryback the microphone? And people were like, oh, he basically just recapped what he said on Jericho's podcast.
Oh, because everyone hears Jericho's podcast?
Exactly. It's like, dude, nobody... Are you kidding me? Like, millions of people are watching this. Thousands of people listen to Jericho. There's a huge difference. You know, like... then again, wrestling fans for you, so...
Yeah, that's all the...
Gotta knock some sense into them. Good fucking luck.
Goddamn IWC.
Goddamn IWC.
Anyway, next...
You know what I want to do? If I become wealthy and I just want to waste money, do you know what I want to do?
Tell me.
I want to make a reality show where we just follow wrestling fans.
Oof.
Like the weird ones, you know?
Like Songman.
Exactly.
That's what you're getting at.
Those and like the ones that haven't showered for like 5 weeks, just been watching the network for 5 straight weeks, you know?
Okay, so TNA fans.
Well, I said the network. TNA marks, they don't watch the network because they're only TNA fans.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, I'm sorry.
They're loyal.
Yeah.
They have to be to still be watching that shit, so I guess they're really loyal.
That's big.
But I really want to see that, man. I think that would be really interesting to see just maybe like a 15-episode series, each episode dedicated to a different wrestling fan. I think that would be gold.
That could be. There you go, Shaheen. See, if I ever got rich, I would do something completely different.
I'm sure you, probably most people would.
Yeah, I would.
I have to see this. You know, I need to make this happen.
I would get a big swimming pool, and in the middle of it, I would put a mechanical bull with a retractable bridge to walk out to this mechanical bull. But that's what I would do if I got rich.
That's actually pretty cool. I like that.
I think it would be badass, and if I ever win the lottery, you are going to see it.
Nice.
Because that is what I want to do.
Maybe we should start up one of those, what are they called, the Kickstarters?
Kickstarter, make me a millionaire.
No, let's do that for the wrestling series, man. Let's make this happen.
Oh, you mean I can't get my mechanical bowl in the middle of the
pool? No, man, fuck that. Fuck that shit.
Book that.
Book that. No, I'm serious, man. I don't know. I think it'd be really good. You know?
That next picture.
Next picture. What's the next picture?
You don't want to know.
Oh, dude. Should I click it or no?
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, you're a dick.
I am.
Oh, that's cool. Ew. You mind tattoos now? Would you want this? Man.
Well, come on. They're all different, my man.
True. But that's too many curious things, man.
Yeah, that's...
God, that thing looks beat up, too.
That's probably the main point there. Yeah. Meanwhile, you get 9 or 10 beers in me, and she might start looking pretty good.
That thing probably feels like sticking your dick in a fucking bowl of mashed potatoes.
Oh, God!
No good. That can't be good, man. That cannot be good. Good God. It's like, you know, you take a bowl of mashed potatoes and just put like a shot of acid inside and stick your dick in there. That's exactly what that probably is.
Think of that movie Soul Plane.
Whole plane. That was a terrible movie.
Dude, I like bad movies.
I think I watched like 5 minutes of that, and I was like, oh my God, this is the worst shit ever.
I got a real weird thing for bad movies.
I can see.
I do. I'm not going to lie.
I like bad movies, but I like bad movies like Toxic Avenger and you
okay,
know.
I like that.
Yeah, I like bad movies like that, you know.
I'm really, really, really a sucker for bad comedies.
Yeah, like I like old school bad movies. You know, like the new school ones. Not really.
Well, pretty much any 80s movie, I'm gonna watch it.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
I mean, I was only 3 years old in the 80s, but.
Yeah. See, I was, you know, I was in my you know single digit years, but I was still, you know, I remember a lot of stuff from 80s and early 90s. So.
Yeah. Same. A lot of the stuff I went back on, so. I enjoyed it still. 80s and 90s, definitely the best time.
Yeah, chat room loves your bowl of mashed potatoes comment.
I'm serious. That's probably what it would feel like.
It wasn't even a plate. It was a bowl. It was just a bowl.
Like nasty-ass mashed potatoes.
Like I picture like a serving bowl, a big, deep serving bowl of mashed, filled with mashed potatoes and just... All right, let's stop this. Let's go.
Can't be good, man.
It can't.
I mean, honestly, if you look at it for a second, it's just, oh, dude.
I did. That's where
it looks like it's alive.
I did. I just, all I know is probably 9 or 10 beers, and I'd probably be,
Man, I feel, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and say that. If you're going to bang that after 9 or 10 beers, dude, I feel bad for your penis.
But I'm here. Hey, where'd you go?
I'm right here. I said, if you're going to beat that vagina after 9 or 10 beers, dude, I feel bad for your dick. don't put your dick in situations like that, man.
Let me say this.
Let it respect your peace.
I'll say this. This would not be the worst piece I had ever had.
That's why I said I feel bad for your dick. If you're going to smash that, I'm sure there's been worse things.
I'm not a bad wingman.
I bet, man. I'm about to move to Texas, man. Let's make this happen.
I'll take one. I can't do it anymore. But I used to be a good wingman. I would definitely I would take the hits for the team a lot.
There you go, man. You're a team player.
Well, because like I always said, you know, my dad always said, a piece you pass up is a piece you don't get.
Yeah, but there's a lot of pieces I don't want to get.
Well?
Like probably most pieces of ass walking around, I don't want it.
This is why they make alcohol. This is why the prohibition was lifted.
True, but then you got to keep in mind, I don't really drink, so.
See, this is where you're missing the boat.
Yeah. I can't drink, man. I get very angry when I'm drunk. I'm like one of those angry drunks, you know?
Yeah.
So it's
by the way, that comment I said my dad said, honest to God, 100% truth. My dad honestly did say that to me when I was 14 years old.
That's a good tip.
It was. It was a good tip, and I lived by it from like 15 and a half on. I lived by that rule.
Man. God bless your dick, man.
Well, I got some kids. It still works. That's what counts.
I think that comment deserves a no homo. No homo, but God bless your dick for going through war.
No homo, God bless your dick. Oh, that's fucking funny.
Man.
I dropped my empty beer doing that. Sorry.
I heard it. Yeah. Oh, shit.
It was empty. It's cool.
Cool, dude.
See, my dad would always tell me that, and my dad's dad would always tell me, if you ever in your life get into a bar fight and there's a guy and a girl, you punch that girl in the face, and while he's down there checking on her, you kick him right in the fucking.
That is terrible advice.
He said it never fails unless they don't give a shit about that woman, and then you're in trouble.
Man, that is some bad advice. Kids, do not take that advice.
Oh, no, take that advice. It will work.
I'm sure it will work, but just don't take it unless you like going to jail. And
I've only had it like once, and I didn't punch her, but...
Yeah, unless you like going to jail and getting raped like Gucci, man.
Yeah, but that was my grandfather. He's been gone for a while, but he was a funny, funny guy.
Yeah. May he rest in peace.
Yeah.
Man, what the fuck? There's a picture of... this is really weird. It's from a house show, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Christian is clearly just grabbing Chris Jericho's ass. Like, while they're hugging. Like a huge palm. Like a fistful of his ass.
I think he mentioned that in...
So weird.
I think Jericho mentioned that once. About just how they used to play around like that at house shows. They would do weird stuff like that.
Oh, dude, the passion in his face, it almost looks like he just wants to bang him. It's fucking weird.
Well...
Questionable.
There you go. Questionable.
Very questionable.
Yeah.
Definitely. That's what Christian should do. Just get a big question mark tattooed on him.
On his face?
Yeah, just what the fuck.
The new Riddler?
There you go.
Jesus Christ. God damn. All right, we only got one more match in the ending segment, so let's
do that. God.
All right. And this match is not going to... Well, actually, we will talk about it a little bit. Big E, Adam Rose.
Unfortunately, I didn't see this. Well, probably fortunately, I didn't see this. So.
Hold on. God damn it. There's cops pulling up outside the building. Anyway, I'm not...
Oh, shit.
They ain't here for me, bro. Trust me. There's some really weird people in this building, which is why I carry a weapon when I leave here at night.
Oh, shit.
This is why you get a concealed weapons permit in the state of Texas.
There you go, man.
Big E, Adam Rose. Big E wins by disqualification because he was attacked by two masked, body-suited Rosebuds who then turned out to be... Wait a minute. Who then turned out to be... Cesaro and Tyson Kidd.
Are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm not. I am totally not joking. I am totally not. I'm not joking.
Wait, so are they actual Rosebuds now?
No. They were dressed as Rosebuds. They came out... And, you know, the match was going on. Next thing you know, these two guys just come in, start attacking him, and they're in, like, real, like, bodysuits, like, skin-tight, those, like, latex suits.
Yeah.
And, next thing you know, man, they do a blockbuster from the top rope, and Big E was on, that would have been Cesaro's shoulders. He could barely hold him. And that's what happened, man. It was Cesaro and Tyson Kidd.
This is, I don't know, man. I like that tag team, but
I don't know. You missed all this?
What's that?
You missed all this?
I missed all that.
Oh, man. You missed just amazement.
I don't know if I want to rewind and watch that.
No.
Yeah, probably not. I don't know, man. Fucking New Day sucks. I mean, I don't really care for them at all. In all honesty, actually, there's going to be a lot of filler in the Rumble because, like, those are three guys that I don't want to see in the Rumble, which I know they're going to be there. You know?
Yeah.
Like, guys like that, Matadors and Titus Owens, like, these guys, I don't want to see these guys.
I know, man. I know, but it's, I mean, I don't know. I don't see many surprises for the Rumble this year, to be honest. So
I don't either, man. I don't either.
I don't either. So, or like you said, they're gonna bring back Dolph and Ryback and, you know, Rowan and ooh, big surprise. Who gives a shit?
And definitely Orton. I mean, Orton's gonna be one. You know.
Orton could, but yeah, Orton could definitely be a well. And that's not even a surprise.
Exactly.
So.
He's been gone for like a month. This, I don't know. Not really much of a surprise.
No. Not at all. So, I don't know. But anyway, after that, the show ends. The Authority comes out. They're doing this whole thing with the John Cena Appreciation Night. They come out. They're, you know, going through all this stuff with Cena, and they bring out Rowan and Dolph and Ryback, and they do this whole spiel, and then they start walking up the ramp, and they decide to fire all three of them, and they blame John Cena. Authority says, hey, here's your great John Cena, it's all his fault. Confetti, balloons, ballyhoo.
Well, now, I did like how it was kind of surreal. Like, I don't know, just going off TV with three guys getting fired. Of course they're not really fired, but, you know. And John Cena just kind of being responsible for that, essentially. But I don't know, man. I mean, I think it could kind of be cool if they had the proper amount of time to actually play this thing out. But they have to bring them back in like 2 weeks, so it's like, well, what's really the point of this?
Exactly. They're really canceling out a lot of what they do, like a week after it's done. The Authority's been off TV 6 weeks and they're already back on television.
Exactly. So it's like, you know, they got fired and they're back in like fucking 6 weeks, and these guys are going to get fired and they're back in 2 weeks. So next time they do a firing angle, it's like, well, who gives a shit? He'll be back in a week.
Yeah. Oh, I'm sure Cena will do something to save it.
Of course, it's Superman.
Yeah. So, yeah. Anyway, that was Raw, unless you got anything else to say about it.
No, just God has blessed us to get it, you know, get it together and go through another episode of Raw, so I'm thankful for that. Because at times, man, it's tough talking about this shit.
It is, man. But I think we're going to get into a much better show. I think we're going to get into New Japan next.
Yeah.
All right, man. And I'm sure you want to get that dinging out of your ear.
Absolutely, because that thing is driving me crazy.
All right. Well, let's do this. Let's take a quick... Let me get everything that I need to get loaded up here. And we can take a quick break. I will go piss.
Well, while you do that, I'm going to give our plugs... In case somebody doesn't watch the next video, you can join us on Facebook, facebook.com/groups/THC podcast. You can subscribe to us on iTunes, on Stitcher, under THT Wrestling Podcast. You can go on YouTube, type in THT Wrestling Podcast or the Turnbuckle Corner, hottag.weebly.com. Check it out, man. A whole bunch of different ways to check us out, so... And Twitter also.
There you go.
Yep. So, iTunes, YouTube, Google Plus, Stitcher.
Stitcher?
That's a new one. Stitcher. There you go.
That is a new one. But yeah, I think that's everything. So.
Live listeners, we're gonna post a new link in the chat room, and I'll post it on the not the message board, the Facebook as well. So. Check us out in a couple minutes. We'll take a quick break, and we'll be back in about 5 minutes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back for the second part. If you missed this, well, I guess you're not missing this. If you missed the last one, go check that out. It should be on my page. Please go ahead and subscribe. Join us on iTunes. THT Wrestling Podcast. Join us on Stitcher, THT Wrestling Podcast, hottagpodcast.weebly.com. You can join us on YouTube, obviously, Turnbuckle Corner, Hot Tag Podcast. And yeah, what else do we have?
I think you got it.
I got it? All right, awesome. Well, we are back. We're going to, Shaheen, man, go ahead and please introduce yourself.
Boxman.
He's the box man.
I just heard the Ass Man song, so it was right there.
Yeah, he had it on for the listeners during the break, but yeah, if you know, we had some good discussion on the last part of the show. We're talking about Raw and Royal Rumble and a bunch of different stuff. So please go ahead and check that out, and please spread the word, share this. You know, if you enjoy it, subscribe, definitely helps us out. So help us out. It'll help you out. We'll give you a good product. Help us out. We'll help you out. Help us out. We'll help you out. That's how the world works, you know? Good shit. Anyway, Global Force Wrestling presenting New Japan's Wrestling, Tokyo Dome Show, Wrestle Kingdom 9, for the first time available in the United States legally. So I was a good man. I purchased it for $45 HD. I know a lot of shitty people went out there and stole it. So if you are one of those people, shame on you. You are a bastard, sir. And you are the reason why wrestling is shitty, because you won't pay for it. So the good stuff doesn't make a profit. So the good stuff doesn't come back. So if you like the product, support it. Good stuff. Anyway, Boxman, please.
Yeah, what he said.
What I said.
Well, I could have just said, well...
Alright. Overall, what did you think of the show? I thought it was fantastic, man. If you wanted wrestling, this is wrestling. You got wrestling, you got 4 hours of wrestling, although I thought 4 hours was a bit much, but it was good wrestling. I enjoyed myself.
Well, and if you watched the pre-show, it was 5 hours.
Holy shit.
Yeah, there was a New Japan 15-man rumble on the pre-show, which was another hour. I did not watch that match. I probably should have. Overall, I thought this show was great. It was top to bottom wrestling. Maybe the fact that I couldn't understand what was happening in between was a good thing, because I didn't even listen. I just walked away till I heard the music for the ring. I thought the production value was, I guess I would say, stellar.
Nice.
It was great. I loved the entrance, the entranceway. All the TVs up there looked great. They had a ton of them. They had tickers on the bottom going to introduce people and keep their names up on the screens. I liked it. I really did. I liked the whole show. I thought it looked great. It felt great. It was a ton. I mean, that, like you said, if you like wrestling, this was a wrestling show.
Absolutely. And yeah. The pre-show actually had a Jushin Thunder Liger.
Yeah, I guess it had a bunch of guys.
Taka Michinoku and Tiger Mask as well.
And I also didn't realize, 24 hours after this show, these guys did another show.
Really?
They did, and I think it was called Dream something, but New Japan put on another show 24 hours after this, and God bless these guys, because they worked their ass off for this show. So I don't even know what they could have done 24 hours later.
Yeah, man, definitely really good in-ring stuff. The show started out with the Young Bucks against Forever Hooligans and Rocky Romero, man. I really like that guy. He's been around there, I think, since, like, the mid-2000s. So, I mean, it's good to see these guys doing the big shows. Young Bucks against the Forever Hooligans, against the Red Dragon from Ring of Honor. Of course, if you're a Ring of Honor fan, you're familiar with them. And they faced the Time Splitters. So this was a fucking awesome match, man.
I really like that Time Splitters group, man. I do want to preface all this with saying I don't know much about New Japan wrestling or Japanese wrestling. So if I sound like kind of a fanboy mark, sorry. Yeah.
Well, I'm going to go ahead and say this. I'm very familiar with Japanese wrestling, but not New Japan. So I don't know too many of these guys. Well, of course, I know pretty much everybody in this match, but I enjoyed it. It was. I wouldn't say it's my first, you know, New Japan experience. I've seen a lot of it, but I've never really followed it, so it was something new. I definitely, you know, I got invested into it more than I did before, obviously, since it was live, and, you know, watching something live is different than watching a show from 5 years ago. And it's a different feel to it, so it was definitely good, man. The match was fantastic. The Young Bucks, hands down, my favorite tag team right now. Just phenomenal.
Yeah, and I hearing it in English was even better. I thought Stryker and JR did pretty damn good. I mean, it took them a while to get gelled, I guess you could say, to gel together a little bit. But
yeah,
there were a few little, you know, where they kind of stepped on each other, this and that. But it was still a good. It was still good. JR can still make a match sound way better than it is.
Yeah.
So, and Stryker had, and, you know, Stryker knows all these guys, and he knows the history, which made it even better.
Well, what I didn't understand, I mean, don't get me wrong, I thought it was really good commentary, certainly better than anything else that we see on TV now. But right. I think people were really just overrating this commentary team. I mean, they were saying, oh, this is like the... You know, like they were just fucking 5 out of 5, just fantastic team. I mean, it was really good, but like you said, there was a lot of hiccups. I mean, I don't really think Matt Stryker is the perfect guy to work with JR. A lot of people like the chemistry. I personally didn't really like it, but I really like JR. Just Matt Stryker, he's all right. Don't get me wrong, I didn't dislike it, but I can't say I thoroughly enjoyed it. But it was good, definitely, you know, better than passable.
Yeah, and I like Stryker, so that might be one thing that, you know, maybe that's why. I think he's really good. I like getting information while I'm watching a show, so...
Absolutely.
I like his style because of that.
Absolutely. Yeah, so. You want to get fed information if you're not familiar with the product, man. That's the whole point of a fucking color commentary team, you know?
Exactly.
But, yeah, this match, you know, definitely one of my favorite matches on this show. First match, it was fucking awesome, man. I can't really – there was a lot of spots in there. I mean, you know, we can't go over all the spots. But it was yeah, really good stuff. Go ahead.
No, I really like that Time Splitters team. I think – I like their logo. It's Back to the Future. It's awesome. I liked it. Yeah.
By the way, for people that didn't watch the show, Time Splitters are Alex Shelley from TNA and Kushida. I guess he was in TNA for a little bit, right?
What a match, man. What a match.
Now, I know Alex Shelley was in TNA. You broke up for a little bit, so I don't think you heard me. But was Kushida, his tag team partner in the Time Splitters, was he in TNA briefly?
Kushida, I think, was... Samoa Joe's little guy who was kind of like Kato.
Oh, okay.
And along that storyline just kind of fell out. And that's some good shit I was watching.
Yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely like that whole thing. But... I don't know, but yeah, that first match had me hooked right there. Like I said, my 6-year-old watched this whole show with me, all 4 hours of it, and to get a 6-year-old attention for 4 hours, I was amazed.
You need to give him a Barry Horowitz pat on the back.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. I did one better. I threw him around that night.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's always good.
Yeah, I wasn't hurting him, but, you know, obviously. He likes when I throw him around. It's fun. That's what couches are for.
That is what couches are made for.
Yeah.
That and making babies.
Right, yeah. Well, this was no more babies. Stop.
Yeah. I don't have any babies, so I'm good in that.
Yeah, stop. So,
how many do you have? 2?
Yeah, 2.
Yeah, that's enough, man.
Matter of fact, my other one had his second birthday just yesterday.
Nice.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Happy birthday.
He turned 2 yesterday, and he made himself very messy with the cake.
Well, that's always fun for a 2-year-old, man.
Throw them in the bath when they're done. So that's what you're supposed to do. So
there you go. So happy birthday, little box man.
Happy birthday, Dylan. Good job. There you go. There you go. So,
next match, we got Hiroyoshi Tenzan and Satoshi Kojima and Tomowaki Hama. I hope I didn't botch those names. I tried.
I'm going to let you say them.
All right. And they faced the Bullet Club, which was a bad luck fail. And this guy, he's pretty fucking big, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. I didn't know who he was, but he's a big dude.
Yeah, I've seen some clips of him with, like, the Bullet Club, but this was my first match that I actually saw. I mean, he's not great or anything, but, I mean, he has a good look, you know, I like it. So Bad Luck Fail and Jeff Jarrett and Yujiro Takahashi. So Karen Jarrett was also on ringside. This was a fairly short match, which was fine with me. They were older guys.
This seemed like it was kind of their, okay, here's one match that you guys will understand, and it's just kind of a fun, quick TV-style match. That's what it seemed like to me.
Yeah, plus it was like, do you remember the one guy from WCW?
Jeff Jarrett?
No. One of the guys from the opposing team. I think it was, was it Kojima?
You know what? I think, didn't Stryker mention that one of them was on WCW at one time, I thought?
Yeah, he was on Nitro for a while.
It might have been Kojima. I don't remember. I there was a lot of flipping and drinking back in those days.
Yeah, it was the guy that had, like, the, not like a mohawk, but almost like a mullet mohawk, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That guy. He used to be in WCW for a while.
Huh. I don't know. Like I said, I think this was just their, okay, this is a quick TV-style match, and it was fun. They got, you know, Hanma out there, who's kind of a mix between Ultimate Warrior and Hulk Hogan. So, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I liked it. It was a fun, quick match, and, you know, the good guys won, so... Jeff Jarrett did his usual stuff out there, you know, went out there. You got a guitar shot to his own teammate and lost a match for him. So I don't know. I liked it. It was fun. It was quick. It was done.
Absolutely. Yeah, it got the point across, you know.
It did. It did. And like I said, I really think this was their way of giving you a quick TV match that, you know, just kind of a filler match, and they still made it good.
Yep, and the next match was some guys from Noah Wrestling, Noah Japan. Mm-hmm. Mikey Nichols, I guess.
Yep.
Naomichi Marufuji, Shane Haste, or Haast, however the hell you say this guy's name, right. And Toru Yano. And they defeated Suzuki Gun. How the fuck do you say these things?
Suzuki.
There you go, which consists of Davey Boy Smith Jr., which is Harry Smith, I guess that's his real name.
Right.
Lance Archer, Shelton Benjamin, and Takashi Iizuka. So right. this was a good match, man. I like Harry Smith. Lance Archer, I saw him at House of Hardcore for the first time. Yeah, he's all right. Shelton Benjamin, it was good to see that guy again. So I thoroughly enjoyed this one. It was nothing that, you know.
And I like Lance Archer. I think he's damn good.
Yeah, I don't think he's bad or anything. I just, you know.
I like him. He looks a lot different. He's bigger. He's got a big, bushy beard now. And
where was he originally?
He was in... He was originally in TNA as Lance Hoyt.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they would chant, Hoyt, 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 Hoyt. He was in, and then
I do remember that.
You do?
I think so, because, I mean, I you know, came back to wrestling here and there. Every couple of years, I would, you know, watch, like, an episode. I remember something, you know, similar to the Hoyt thing. So, yeah. So, TNA, those are his origins.
Yes, it is. TNA, and then he was at, well, that's where I, wait a minute. Well, that's the first place I had ever seen him.
Well, that's all that matters, right?
Well, yeah, of course, that's all. And then he went to WWE and was Vance Archer, if I remember correctly, not Lance, Vance. Yes.
Just kind of mixed the names together?
Yeah, it was Vance Archer. So, and you know, he was, he was just getting ready to do a tag team with, was it Curt Hawkins? And they were just about to get over. I mean, they were literally there, and then he was gone.
Yeah.
One day, just gone. So, I don't know. Gone. But I liked him in TNA. I liked him in WWE. And I thought he looked good here, too. Maybe, again, I'm a fan, so what can you do?
What did you think of Shelton Benjamin?
Shelton Benjamin always looks good.
Yeah.
Always looks good. He was... always out there I don't know. He's always good to me. I think he got a pretty shitty run in.
Oh, absolutely, dude. Absolutely.
And I really blame a lot of that on Charlie, who got fired for being drunk on the job.
I was never really a big fan of Charlie Haas, man.
And that's public. That's a public story. I'm not saying anything here that no one knows. So
there you go, man. Breaking news about Charlie Haas.
Yeah. Always good to see Shelton Benjamin. I wish he'd come back to WWE and just not cut promos because he can't talk for shit.
Do you think he's just as good as he used to be, though?
I think so.
Yeah? You don't think he missed a step?
I don't think he has. Didn't look like it. I mean, he didn't do that much in the ring, but...
Right.
I mean, you know, I actually, Davey Boy did most of the match, I think.
Yeah, I like him a lot, man. I think Harry Smith is pretty decent.
Yeah, and he got another one. They could have capitalized on his lineage and just decided to let him go instead.
Yeah, but I actually like him in Japan. I think he fits fairly well with the Japanese roster.
A lot of these guys can get out there and do, you know, I'm glad these guys have somewhere to go, even if it's, you know, on the other side of the country, but at least they got somewhere to go. They can make some decent money and still work.
Yeah. Next match, we got Minoru Suzuki, which I'm actually familiar with, and he defeated Kazushi Sakuraba, I'm sorry.
Yes, very popular name. Do not say it wrong. So I know both these guys, too, from MMA.
Well, actually, I know Suzuki from, like deathmatch wrestling.
They're also both MMA fighters. Suzuki usually has the, you know, black hair and black trunks, so it was weird to see him with the white hair and white trunks, but it was cool. It was pretty cool. Sakuraba, man, those fucking ears on that guy. Jesus.
Yeah, cauliflower.
They're like Randy Couture bad, but I liked the match. It was fun. My son loved it.
Please, enlighten me a little bit on both of these guys as far as their MMA background, because I know Suzuki's like wrestling background, but as far as like Sakuraba, I wasn't really familiar with him. I did some YouTube searches and I watched this thing with like Ken Shamrock and all that, but
yeah, Sakuraba's been around for a long time in the MMA world. I don't know like a ton about him, but I've heard the name. I know he's done a few of the Pancrase events, which one of the guys from one of these matches is the founder of Pancrase, and I forgot who it was. I think it was one of the guys from the last match. And I know he's done some other stuff, but yeah, he's a legend in the MMA world.
Oh, okay. Did he ever compete in the U.S.? Like with like UFC or anything?
Uh-huh.
Really? I never saw him in the UFC. I never...
Early.
I'll have to check him out.
Let me see here. How early? Good question. How early? But I know it was early UFC.
I know he was in Pride, because that's the footage that I saw.
Sakuraba. UFC.
Yeah, UFC Japan heavyweight tournament winner. When was this?
Yeah, he did some in Japan, I'm pretty sure. I know he did some Metamoris. He did some Gracie fighting. Maybe he wasn't in UFC. I lied. He didn't. He was only doing... He did the Japan shows, and he was in Pride.
Yeah.
So I think there's a picture of him with Bob Sapp.
There you go, man. There you go. But yeah, this was pretty decent. I mean, it was pretty much just like scripted MMA.
It's I heard someone call it faux MMA. It's basically what it is. It's work shoot, half MMA, half wrestling. But it was still a good match.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. Suzuki defeated him with like a chokehold.
Mm-hmm.
It was decent. It was what it was. It was a pretty stiff match. I mean, you could hear the kicks. You could hear those fucking kicks, man.
But I like the story Suzuki told in the ring. Even though it was a fake MMA match, Suzuki still sold that left arm. I mean, dude, there was there was a minute there I thought his wrist was broken from that Kimura.
Oh, and yeah, even JR sold the hell out of it, man.
Of course, and he sold the shit out of it. And, you know, won, and he only used the right hand to do the choke. He sold it, and he sold it the whole match, which I liked it. I thought it was pretty damn good.
Yeah, and I like how he threw down the ice pack.
Yeah, right at the top of the ramp, he threw it down, like, I don't need this shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely liked it. I thought he did a good job selling that on that wrist and arm, and yeah, I don't know. You know, Sakuraba was kicking it, and he sold it every time he got near it. He sold it.
Yeah, the next match was for the. This is a really weird name for a championship belt. It's called the Never Open Weight Championship, which is not really like it's not similar to like a hardcore championship, but I guess it's like a like more of like a brawling style, like a stiff style.
Mm.
So I guess. That's what it is. And yep. it was Togi Makabe against Ishii. And I really liked Ishii. I thought he was awesome.
Yeah, it was a stiff match. This was a stiff one, too.
Oh, yeah. They even sprayed them down after the match.
Yeah. This was a good match, though. I liked it. Yeah, they were spraying them. And, I mean, they run in there with those ice packs after the matches, man, because of how stiff they are.
Oh, yeah. I bet, man. Yeah. That's why I'm surprised they did a show the next night. I mean, these guys.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, they worked their ass off this night. I can't believe what they did afterwards. I wish I could get the name of that damn show.
Yeah.
I don't feel like looking at
it. I really liked this match, though. It was stiff. It was good, and it really introduced people to, like, the Japanese style, you know?
Oh, definitely, yeah. They were doing some of those, you know, some of those drivers.
Forms.
Yeah, those drivers were
lining. Lines, absolutely.
Yeah, it was good. I liked it. Yep, and Makabe won that one, and I thought that was a great match, though.
Yeah, definitely. And Makabe, I was reading his Wikipedia. He's been around, I think, since like 03. So he's been around for quite some time.
Nice. Yeah, and Weeble in the chat saying, Sakuraba has beat a few of the Gracies, Henzo, Hoyler, Ryan and Hoist. So if you can beat a Gracie, you're a badass.
Yeah, he looked fairly small, but you know, I guess that doesn't really say much.
Oh, fairly.
He's older now.
Fairly small in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is
yeah, it's nothing.
It's nothing. Yeah.
But next match we got Kenny Omega. Are you familiar with Kenny Omega?
You know, I am, and one of the reasons I'm familiar with him is that match against that 9-year-old girl.
What?
Wait a minute. You've never seen this?
I have never seen a match against a 9-year-old girl. What the hell?
My friend.
Oh, I need to check this out.
Where can I post this? I'll post it in the chat because I think someone might have posted it on the Facebook earlier. Hold on.
Oh, I found it.
You did?
Yeah. Now, please, while I watch this, just go ahead and give me your opinion on this match. I need to watch this for a second.
On the 9-year-old match?
No. On the Kenny Omega and...
Whatever. Oh, okay. I got you. On the Kenny Omega versus
Taguchi. Yeah.
This was another good match. Kenny Omega's style is a little odd. He's a very weird guy, but... It was a good match. I enjoyed it. I had fun. I don't know. I'm not very the only way I'm familiar with Kenny Omega is through that one little match I've seen him in. So Kenny Omega is just kind of a funny character, but looks like he's one of the Bullet Club because the Young Bucks came down to the ring with him. And Kenny Omega took the title here for the IWGP Junior Heavyweight Championship. So,
yeah, I think he's pretty good, man. I like him. Yeah, he joined the Bullet Club about 2 months ago, something like that.
Yeah. I saw Matt and Nick going, the Young Bucks running down with him, so I knew that had to be that.
Yeah,
somebody else.
They're awesome.
Oh yeah, they are.
This is weird, man. Why is he wrestling a 9-year-old girl?
This was a few years ago this match happened. I don't even know when it was. It was,
It's just like, why? Like, I don't... It was for the shock value? Like,
it was obviously a show that they were doing, but I don't know. But I don't think... I don't know. It was a flea market. What?
This is weird.
It was at a flea market, so I guess they were just doing a match.
It's just very weird. One of the weirdest things I've seen in Japan, believe me, I've seen some weird shit in Japan. I've seen, like, jellyfish matches and all that weird stuff.
Yeah. But, yeah, I can't believe you've never seen that match.
Ooh, Jesus, man. He actually threw the hell out of her into the turnbuckle.
Yeah, at one point he does.
Jesus Christ. That looked like it hurt. Well, she got a concussion probably. Man. Yeah. All right, anyway, I guess next match. That's very awkward to watch.
It is. I've watched it once or twice. So, all right, next match.
Got Shibata and Goto, and they defeated the Bullet Club. So what the fuck?
Yeah.
Doc Gallows and Carl Anderson. This surprised me because I didn't really think much of these guys, to be honest with you.
With all the press that Gallows and Anderson were doing, I was a little surprised they lost, too, because I heard Anderson on, like, two different shows.
Yeah.
So, you know, I was a little surprised that he lost. So,
but, did you like these guys, Shibata and Goto?
Yeah. Yeah.
They weren't bad, but I don't know, man.
I liked them. I mean, they're not big guys. They're both kind of tiny. A little skinny, actually, but they could go in the ring, man.
All right. So I like Gallows' face paint, though.
Yeah, that was a little weird, Gallows. But again, another place for him to go work, and he's making a name for himself. So good for him, and great, good job, awesome.
Kind of reminds me of the Barbarian when he was in like Powers of Pain.
He did look a little barbarianish.
Or a warlord, actually, I should say.
Yeah, there you go. Who we were talking about earlier.
There you go. Well, next match, I enjoyed this one a lot. AJ Styles against Naito. And Naito is pretty awesome, man. He had a match with Jeff Hardy, actually, that I watched.
Yeah, I really enjoyed this match. Really enjoyed this match. And you could tell by the... I couldn't understand one word the video package said before this match, but you could tell they were playing up how dangerous AJ Styles' finishing move was.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could tell by the video that's what they were doing because they kept showing all the mishaps that have happened lately. And then to have him win with that move off the second rope, I thought was clever, clever, clever.
I was going to say that, man. I think it was very ballsy, and I appreciate it. You know, it was like, okay, everybody's telling me to, you know, ban this move. You know what? I'm going to do it from the second rope.
Yeah, exactly. It was a nice little, you know, kind of a fuck you.
Yeah. And it showed confidence, you know?
Yeah, definitely. And you know what? If you look at somebody in that move, you can tell. If you keep your head straight, there's like almost no way you can get hurt.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to sound like one of those guys that knows how to wrestle. I don't at all. I've never been trained. I've never even, you know.
Just by watching it.
Yeah, but just, yeah, exactly. By watching, it doesn't really look like it's that hard to take. I mean, a lot of other moves look way worse than that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, just the DDTs they do there look worse.
Yeah, even fuck a powerbomb, man. I mean, if you don't know how to land right, you're smacking the back of your head on the floor.
Yeah, which we've all seen it. We've all seen the head bounce off the mat.
Yeah, so, I mean, I don't know, man. I think it's either AJ Styles is getting slower and he can't do the move right, or it's just a couple people that just didn't know how to take the move right. So, I don't know. I don't think it's him. It's him operating the move incorrectly. I think it's just people probably aren't familiar with how to take the move.
Yeah, I agree. And it's, like I said, when you're watching it, it looks like all you got to do is don't tuck that head. And I could see where it would be instinct for someone to do it, but anyway.
Yeah.
I thought it was a great match. I thought the ending, like I said, I thought it was a very clever ending. And as much as little as I know about the storyline, I think it tied it up nice.
Yeah, and the next match, I really like this one, as I like the last match. You know, these actually the last three match and the first match. Those are definitely my favorite ones. But yeah. Shinsuke Nakamura defeated Kota Ibushi, which was an awesome match, man. I mean, at first, when they first came out, I was like, oh, this probably isn't going to be good. And then I watched it, and I was like, holy shit. I mean, I was kind of familiar with Ibushi because I saw his match. Where did I see his match with? I forget, but I did some search before ordering the pay-per-view, and I watched a couple of his matches. And he was pretty good, man. And some of his – did you see the moonsault that he did from the top rope to the outside?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like those spots, man, he's just so clean with it, you know? He's like a well-oiled machine, you know? It's just a well-oiled Japanese wrestling machine.
Japanese machine. He's like a Suzuki or a Honda.
That's a tongue twister, isn't it? Well-oiled Japanese wrestling machine. Yeah. Yeah, awesome match, man. It was a long match, 20-minute match. Just a lot of spots. It was not the stiffest match, but stiff enough for me to like it. It was just good, man. It told a story. The commentary put the fucking made it feel important and put the match over. And yeah, a lot of the spots were nice, man. Ibushi's, he's very crisp and clean.
Nice.
And so is Nakamura. Don't you know? Not him at all. He was just as great.
Yeah, I liked it. I liked the match. I thought it was great.
Definitely great match. And that was for the Intercontinental Championship, the IWGP. IWGP. That's a hard one to say. IWGP. IWGP.
There you go.
IWGP.
Yeah, I'm just reading someone here that's not liking much of... Anyway, okay.
Who's not liking what?
Nah, don't worry about it. Go ahead.
What, Japanese wrestling is bad?
I'm just reading some things on Facebook, but...
Nah.
Yeah.
Anyway. The main event.
Ooh, we forgot to hit it for Raw, so let's hit it.
This is your main event of the evening!
Well, this was a well-deserved main event button.
Yeah.
Well, I guess that doesn't really make sense. It was well deserved to press that button for this one. Raw doesn't deserve it. This was a good one. 30 minutes of straight wrestling.
Hey, this was more than 30. This was like a 43 minute match, dude. I think.
On the time it says 30 minutes. I don't know. It seemed like it was longer, but to be honest, they did just fuck around for a while. Like, the entrance was long. When he was leaving, it took him like 20 minutes to get out of the ring.
Yeah, it did. And then he started talking more. Luckily, I cut it off right about then. It was getting loud in my house, so.
Did you find it very weird that a lot of people were giving him towels to wipe his sweat on?
I did find a little weird, people throwing him towel. I mean, who is he, fucking Elvis?
Yeah, it was just Elvis weird.
That he would wipe his sweat and hand it to the women, and they would scream and pass out.
And I actually saw him, like, wipe his nose with one.
Oh.
You clearly see, like, the snot. And it's like, dude, what the why? Why would anybody want this? You know? But then again, at the first Extreme Rising, there was a match. What was that you cut out? I couldn't hear you.
I wouldn't want a snotted, sweaty towel, but
yeah,
I guess that's me.
Well, worse than that, let me go ahead and share this short story real quick. First Extreme Rising, there was a match with Axel Rotten against Balls Mahoney, and it was right before the intermission. So, of course, they're going to blade, and it was a bloodbath. And at the intermission, they basically just put some fucking tape over their wound, and they're just bleeding all over the merch table, right? All over the 8x10s, all over everything. Anything they're signing has got blood all over it. And mind you, the story with New Jack and Balls being, you know, infected by all these diseases and all this crazy shit just came out like 2 weeks prior to this incident. So in my mind, I'm like, all right, dude, well, that's one table I'm going nowhere near. And right when I'm thinking that, I see this guy bring his kid, right? And the kid has a kendo stick, right? Now just imagine this. Uh-huh. They pay for an autograph for the kendo stick, and they ask Balls Mahoney to drip his blood on the kendo stick. Now, why the fuck would you want that for your kid?
Yeah.
You wonder why there's, like, twisted kids that shoot up schools when they're, like, 12. Good yeah, reason.
Those parents should probably be taken away.
Got hepatitis C on a kendo stick. That should be a match. Hepatitis C on a kendo stick match. It's got a good ring to it.
You call Russo, he'll book it. But it'll be on a pole.
That's fine. Hepatitis C on a fucking...
Hepatitis C on a kendo stick on a pole match.
There you go. That's another tongue twister. God damn.
I got it. Don't worry about it.
Tongue twisting it all night.
Tongue twisting.
I guess that deserves another no homo. Two dudes talking about tongue twisting. That sounds pretty good.
No homo, baby. We just tongue twisting in this dumb bitch. What you gonna do about it? Who, baby? Who?
Oh, man. Man, we had Gucci Man on the other episode. We got Dusty Rhodes making an appearance.
I made it a pants on your toe.
That'd be an interesting... What if we could sit down Dusty Rhodes and Gucci Man for a shoot interview? Rob Feinstein, book it.
Oh, God.
Make this happen, Rob.
Gucci Man come in with a fucking Band-Aid on his ass.
Did you see the pictures with Rob in that photo shoot with like Tammy Lynn Sitch?
Yeah, that's from like a year and a half, 2 years ago.
Yeah, I was actually at that convention.
Where are you? Well, it was about a year and a half, 2 years, right?
Yeah. It was at the Legends of the Ring in New Jersey.
Yeah, I remember seeing that picture a while ago.
Yeah, they were paying like $100 to lay in bed with her for like two. I mean, I'm sure he didn't pay because I guess I think she was actually doing business with him. I think he was one of the vendors that was providing that service, if you will.
Yeah, she'd be a little old and long gender for him anyway.
Yeah.
I'm not
both, gonna, actually.
Let's not get into it.
I don't want to get into anything with that guy.
No. Yeah, let's not get into it. No homo.
No homo. But yeah, man. Okada and Tanahashi.
Yep.
Fucking awesome main event. Awesome, awesome. I'm going to go ahead and give this damn near a five-star match, man. This was fucking awesome. I understand why Dave Meltzer gives these guys five-star matches now. But, yeah, really good wrestling match, man. It was really good. The only thing I don't like about Japanese wrestlers is, like, their outfits, because they all just kind of look like fake Chris Jerichos, you know? And, like, a lot of them were, like, pretty boys. There's no, like, I don't know, like, badass gimmicks. There's no heels, really, you know? It's just, like, regular-looking dudes.
They're rock stars over there, and you can tell. I mean, like you said, Tanahashi's walking out like Elvis trying to put sweat on people's towels. I mean,
yeah.
I don't know.
Tanahashi, man, that guy's awesome, dude.
I've heard that. I don't know much about Japanese wrestling, so I'm not going to pretend I do, but this show got me interested.
That's one guy I've actually watched his matches. He's pretty fucking awesome, dude. He's the guy that faced Kurt Angle a couple years ago.
I remember. I actually have that match. It was one of those rare appearance matches, but I can't post it. I think I have one against him, and I want to say Goldberg.
Really?
In like
I've never seen that one.
I think it was like 2004.
Yeah, I remember he actually did a TNA match, didn't he? I saw that on YouTube somewhere.
Might have, but I'm going to have to look, but I think I got him and Goldberg in a match, too.
Yeah, actually AJ Styles and Tanahashi, TNA.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I think I might remember that.
Yeah.
I don't know. So, I don't know, but I thought it was a great show. I told my overall thoughts. What were yours?
I thought it was fantastic, man. I think honestly, the main event, I mean, it's really early to predict this, but it could definitely be up there for match of the year.
Even JR said that. And he went, I know it's January 4th, but God damn it.
It's true, man. I mean, can you get much better than that? I mean, we don't know anything about the angle or anything, but it didn't really matter. They told the story, and the action spoke for itself, you know?
Yeah, you know what? I think not knowing the storyline might have helped make that show better for me.
Probably. It's probably, like, real corny.
All I cared... Number one, I couldn't understand the promos for the storylines, so it meant nothing. And like I said, I walked away until I heard ring music going, then I walked back pretty much. So all you cared about was, let's see how the wrestling is. Because I didn't understand anything else, so really all I gave a shit about was if it was a good wrestling show, and that was all I took it as. I didn't care what was going on. I enjoyed the commentating, but whatever. Someone on our Facebook said JR sounded like a soundboard, and he was right. For the first probably three matches, JR was just kind of putting out all his old stuff.
Yeah,
he was getting his shit. Yeah, he was getting his shit in, you know. And but after, I think probably after the third match, they really started to go back and forth, and they were, you know, and JR was kind of letting Stryker just do all the information, and JR kind of flipped over to kind of be the color guy.
Yeah.
So
it's funny how the rules change, but
they did.
Speaking of Tanahashi, a couple matches you guys might want to check out. These are the couple matches that I watched before this pay-per-view. Kurt Angle, that's one that we mentioned. Prince Devitt, check that one out. That one was really good. He had one that I really enjoyed with Tanaka, Masato Tanaka.
Mm-hmm.
You guys remember him from ECW, FMW. What else did he have? He had one with Kurt Angle. Kurt Angle and Nakamura against Tanahashi and AJ Styles. That was on G1 Climax. What else? He had one against Prince Albert.
Tensai.
Tensai. That was like half hour long.
Giant Bernard.
Yeah, Giant Bernard. And I didn't watch that one, but I'm actually going to check that out because everybody says he was really good in New Japan, and I can't see that.
I heard the same thing. He was great. He was amazing. But I can because, you know, WWE brings these people in and just, I don't know, man. Sometimes I think WWE kills people's passions about wrestling.
I'm sure they do. I mean, look at CM Punk.
Perfect example. Guys like Punk who love wrestling, and then they come out of there. Listen to some of the guys who have gotten fired from that place. They just don't give a fuck anymore, some of them.
Oh, yeah.
They just don't. I mean, listen to some of those shoot interviews. I know it's a shoot interview. They want to sound like that, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I just think that, I don't know. It's got to be just the worst place. Everything has to be done their way. Yeah. You can't piss anyone off. Don't piss anyone off. All right, pal?
I love that. Well, don't piss anybody off.
It was ridiculous, though. How could...
Such a good answer, though.
Yeah, great answer.
It's amazing.
Be a pussy and never stand up for anything and anyone you believe in. That's a...
Oh, my God. Vince McMahon.
Great fucking do it. I couldn't do it. I couldn't work like that.
Yeah. He actually has a match with Harry Smith that was also
cool.
Davey Boy Smith Jr.
Davey Boy Jr. What was he in WWE?
Wasn't it just Davey Boy Smith Jr.?
No, I think they called him something else. I don't remember.
Whoa. Hold on. This is a weird one.
Oh, a weird one. Uh-oh. Did you say... Uh-oh.
That actually deserves that. Oh. We got Hiroshi Tanahashi against fucking Scott Hall.
Hey, yo.
This is weird.
Man,
weird.
When
it
was
happened,
that?
Though.
When
2001?
2001, right after that makes sense.
Yeah, 2001.
Right after WCW closed, right after the horrible, yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And Scott Hall was still in his, he was still doing great back then, so that's probably a good match.
Yeah. I guess he joined Chono's team in New Japan. And I guess he had a run in New Japan, actually. I didn't know this.
Ah, David Hart Smith, Weeble and Kevin. Correct, both of you guys. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, that's... I didn't know Scott Hall had a career in New Japan.
I had heard him speak about it before, but I don't know how long he was over there. I don't think that was his first trip over there, because he talks about when he was young going over to Japan.
Yeah, I just posted the link in the chat. Anybody wants to check it out?
There it is. Yeah, 2001.
It's weird.
Wow, Hall actually looks a little. Hall looks like a snake in that picture.
He looks decent.
I'm just looking at just in the picture. That's in the chat room. I see you posted it in the chat room. So he looks like Jake the Snake in that picture, but much bigger. God damn, Hall was jacked, dude.
Yeah, he was good in this match. He was moving around fine.
Yeah, I never realized how big he was until those WCW shows where him and Nash were standing together, and it's like, damn. Hall and Nash, I mean, they were like right beside each other. It was pretty fucking good, man, but I loved it. I don't know, but I don't know. Yeah, Scott Hall and Tanahashi, look at that. Tanahashi, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I'll watch that later.
Yeah, should be good stuff.
Yeah.
Well, that was Wrestle Kingdom 9 for you. Hopefully Global Force does some more stuff with them.
I'm hoping they do. I don't know, man. As much as we all made fun of Jeff Jarrett, I kind of understand what he was doing with the putting stuff, you know, just the pictures and stuff. You got to get some income coming in, even if it's not much. You got to get some income coming in. You got to get the name out there for people. And you know what? A koozie and a T-shirt and bumpers and a koozie and a T-shirt are like free advertising. A person buys it, they wear it, and they promote your company.
Exactly.
So,
it hasn't worked for TNA though. They damn near give away T-shirts, and they still can't promote their shit.
Yeah, I don't know. It totally different company. I mean, and New Japan has some established over there, so I don't know. I really thought it was. I don't know. I hope that they did good on this show. I know the app that they were promoting, the Flips app, died because there were over 2,000 people, and they. Weren't expecting that, so obviously they had a good turnout for that, for just the app, so I'm interested to see what numbers this show did.
Yeah, I am as well. I'm guessing, you know, they have to be realistic. They have to be pretty much going for the same numbers as, like, Ring of Honor, you know?
I would say they're probably going for that, so that's what?
6,000.
I think they're probably going for more than that.
10,000 maybe. I mean, they're not getting more than that, dude.
I think they might, dude.
You think so? I don't know.
I think they could. I definitely think they could. I could see them getting up in the maybe 25, 40. This was a big talked about show, man.
25,000?
I knew a lot of people, man, who kept saying they were going to change. They could, man. This could do 25. I'm hoping it does. You know what?
I would put all my money on that, man. There's no way they're getting even near 25,000.
I think they could, man. I mean, I think they could.
I guess we'll see, man. I don't see that happening.
You will,
I'm saying maybe 10,000.
I think you might get 10,000 just on the live show. I think the more this show got talked about, people started picking it up on the later pay-per-view buys.
Yeah.
I hope. I really do. I really hope they did, because it was a show worth every penny.
Yeah, it was a long show, but I definitely enjoyed it.
It was a pretty goddamn long show, but it didn't feel like a very... I mean, it wasn't like Raw, where I'm going, ugh, hour and a half left.
Right.
I never looked to see how much time was left, and it was match for match. I mean, it was match after match after match after match. You didn't get much bullshit. You didn't get much talking. What the hell was that?
Nothing. I was playing something in the background. I was watching a Vince Russo video. Oh, man. God bless that man.
Yeah, so I don't know, man. I hope the best for him, and I hope they do a lot of buys, and we'll find out. I'm guessing in a month here.
Yeah. Hopefully they did some good numbers, and hopefully Ring of Honor is coming back to pay-per-view, because their last pay-per-view was phenomenal. I think it was, what was the one? Last Battle or something like that? Is that what it was called? The pay-per-view, the Ring of Honor one.
Final battle,
yes. Yeah. That was awesome.
Hmm.
Oh, did you ever get to check that out?
No, and I always say I'm going to, and...
Dude, check that out, man. Please do.
I know. I never do, and then this New Japan show, I knew people were going to be talking about, and I didn't want spoils, so I just watched it, never even touched my phone, stayed off the internet, and I was glad I did. I was glad I got to sit down and watch this, but I need to do it with some more shows.
Yeah, I'm telling you, if you get a chance... Even if you just watch the main event, check out Final Battle.
I will.
Really, really good.
I heard great things about it, and I don't read much. I mean, if I don't watch a pay-per-view, I'm not going to read the results, because I think that's kind of a cheap way out, and you really don't see how things play out on paper. Right. So I don't like that. I never appreciated. So I'll check it out, though.
Yeah. And speaking of Ring of Honor, I'm not positive if it is Ring of Honor, but I'm almost positive. The Royal Rumble weekend, Ring of Honor is coming to Philadelphia. They're doing a show at the ECW Arena. So one of the matches is the Young Bucks. And hold on, actually, let me pull this up because I forget.
They should go over to WWE and shake everybody's hand.
Yeah.
Kiss
Vince McMahon's ass.
Especially Booker T.
Let me see where this was.
Fucking Booker T. God, he was bad on commentary last night.
Yeah, he's pretty garbage, dude.
No, there were literally, I mean, they were showing the three-man, and there were literally times JBL and Cole looked at him like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Yep, it's going to be Ring of Honor. Ring of Honor, Saturday, January 24th, ECW Arena. Listen to this. This is going to be awesome. I don't know if you're familiar with some of these guys.
Go for it.
I'm telling you, this is going to be awesome. AJ Styles and the Young Bucks, right? Bullet Club. Know them. Against Matt Sydal. I'm sure you know him.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know Cedric Alexander?
I do.
He's fucking awesome. And ACH, do you know him?
No.
All right. Well, he's pretty much just as good as, you know, the rest of these guys.
I've heard great about him. I personally have never seen him though.
Yeah, but this match, dude, I'm fucking excited. This is gonna be awesome.
Awesome, dude.
I will be there.
Sweet.
Man, we're getting a lot of good wrestling, dude. I'm actually excited for wrestling for once. And it honestly, man, if we're getting a lot of different wrestling, like I'm going to keep up with Pro Wrestling Syndicate. I'm going to keep up with Lucha Underground. Hopefully I can keep up with New Japan when it comes out. Mm-hmm. TNA, hopefully it's better so I can keep up with it. And hopefully Global Force gets a TV deal. What was it? NXT, that's another one. That's like 7-8 shows right there that we can talk about, right? If this actually happens and they're actually decent enough to talk about, I'm going to have to just take a break from WWE, dude, because honestly, it does. You know how you were talking about it kills your passion for wrestling? It actually does. It drains me when I watch it, because it's like, oh, God, I don't want to see this. You know, when you watch Ring of Honor, you're like, holy shit, this is really good. When you watch Lucha Underground, you're like, oh, my God, this is different. You know?
Yeah.
Pro Wrestling Syndicate. It's such a different product because you get the best indie stars, and you get these old legends that you never see anymore, and you get dream matches. It's a different product, you know. Global Force, I'm sure when they come out, they're gonna have luchadors, they're gonna have New Japan guys, they're gonna have Ring of. It's gonna be good stuff, you know. So if you know, God willing, if this happens and we get some good wrestling, then thank God I can take a break from the WWE.
Yeah, I mean, like we were saying at the top of the show, I mean, it 2015 is looking to be a damn good year for wrestling, man. It's as of right now, it's looking to be a good fucking year, man. I'm excited. Like you were saying, Lucha Underground is out there right now, and they are doing amazing. As a matter of fact, they come back tomorrow night. We haven't talked about it in 2 weeks because they were off, but tomorrow night they're back. So
nice.
We'll be talking about them next week, I'm sure.
Maybe let's do like a, if we have time, let's do like a Saturday edition or something.
We could do a Underground Saturday.
Because we're gonna have TNA, and we're gonna have new TNA.
Yep.
We're gonna have new Lucha Underground. You know, so that's a good like an hour and a half hour to talk about that stuff.
Yeah, we can do that. We can do a Lucha Underground Saturday. We can talk.
Because I think if we do like Lucha and TNA and Raw, you know, it's just gonna be it's gonna be oversaturated.
Yeah, we can do that. We can do a Saturday show this week on Lucha, and then Tuesday we'll do Raw, and well, we can even talk about TNA on Saturday. We'll see.
Yeah, definitely. And if we get time, let's. I know I'm gonna watch it. Check out that Pro Wrestling Syndicate. I posted the link. Maybe we can talk about that.
I'll check that out on the. That's on YouTube.
Yeah, it's on YouTube, and I put it right on the Facebook group.
Yeah. I'll check that out when I get home tonight. As I'm, I'll put both shows up on the internet tonight.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, man. I think we've pretty much gone over everything.
That's it.
Time to get out of here.
Done.
Yeah.
Seriously. All right.
We're right about 3 hours and some change.
Yeah, but we have two shows, so it's different.
Oh shit! We can't do 6 hours. Oh man! Plus, I gotta get some food, man. I'm hungry over here. I haven't ate yet.
All right, man. Well, we're gonna let you get out. You want to do our plugs again? You seem to be having it down pat.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, join us on Facebook. You know, converse with us. There's a lot of news that we post up. You know, some cool videos if we find it. So check that out. Plus, we put all our videos on there. So that's on facebook.com/group/THTpodcast. You can find all the links on the website, and that's hottagpodcast.weebly.com. You can join us on Twitter. That's THTpodcast. You can join us on YouTube. I'm sure you're watching it right now if you're watching live, so you already know it. It's Turnbuckle Corner, or you can just search THT Wrestling Podcast. We are now available on Stitcher and iTunes. So that's good news for the Apple, iPhone people. And the goddamn, well, what's the other one?
Apple Stitcher.
No. What's the other product? It's either Apple.
Android.
There you go. So Stitcher for the Android folks, and iTunes for the Apple folks like myself. So you can find us on iTunes and Stitcher. Please leave a comment, like it, subscribe. Please share this. Get us some more eyes, and you can join us on there at THT Wrestling Podcast. So check that out, and we'll be back this Saturday. I'm not sure what time, so I don't know if you guys are going to be able to watch it live necessarily. But, yeah, subscribe, and it'll pop up, you know.
There you go.
That's another good reason to subscribe. You know, we have a little presence just popping up in your phone.
Just popping up. Just boom. Here they are. Boom.
Wake up in the morning, go take a shit, you just go on your phone, oh shit, new THT Wrestling Podcast, what is this, bonus episode, there you go, that's what you get for subscribing, you know?
Oh shit, hot tag, motherfucker.
Oh, shit.
I just got three brand new podcasts sitting here right now because I subscribe to them.
There you go. So yeah, thank you guys for listening. I know we had a couple more viewers tonight, listeners, whatever you want to say, live listeners, and yeah. Yeah, and our downloads have been increasing by the week, so that's good.
Keep comments on YouTube, people. We love them.
So that's good stuff, man. Thank you, folks.
There you go. So I guess that means we hit the end of the show. That's it.
Pack her ass, my good man. Time to kick back, drink some beers, and smoke some weed.
Fine.